on behalf of the director TIFR, who unfortunately is out of Mumbai and could not be here today. So let me read out a message from Professor Sandeep Trivedi, director TIFR. Here's the message. I heartily congratulate Professor Anil Sadgopal on his receiving the Homi Bhabha Award in Science Education. Professor Sadgopal is a pioneer in reforming the school science curriculum, and TIFR is proud of his association with the Institute. The innovations introduced by the Hoshangabad Science Teaching Program continue to influence progressive and enlightened science education curricula in the country to this day. The award is richly deserved, or rather, I should say that the stature of the award is enhanced by his acceptance of it. Professor Sadgopal has remained steadfastly committed to the cause of universalization of education and has poured his energy and effort into furthering this cause. These efforts continue to inspire us to strive towards this goal. That was the message from Professor Trivedi. Let me add a few of my own words from the perspective of the Homi Bhabha Center for Science Education. The Hoshangabad Science Teaching Program and the materials produced, Bal Vaigyanik, the series of textbooks, remain a sort of beacon in the field. There's things that are worth going back to repeatedly. In fact, in the context of one of our recent big programs, the Vigyan Pratibha program, which is developing experiments to nurture interest and talent in science among high school students. We went back, we were designing some experiments in electricity. We went back and looked at the Bal Vaigyanik books, and we found those experiments already so nicely developed and so well structured. And these initiatives, I mean, it's striking to think that they go back nearly half a century. I mean, it's the beginning of the 70s. And I just wanted to mention that also for the sake of our young colleagues, that it's worth looking at these exemplary efforts in experimental-based, inquiry-based science learning. So let me now read out the citation before I hand over the award to Professor Sadgopal. The Homi Bhabha Award in Science Education 2018 is presented to Professor Anil Sadgopal in recognition of his lifelong contribution to a systematic rethinking of science education in India, including impactful experiments in teaching at the grassroots level like Kishore Bharati and Eklavya, leading to the implementation of activity-based, inquiry-oriented education in the school system, as well as spearheading several local and All India People Science movements and sustained interventions aimed at making the national education policies more equitable to achieve universalization of education. So it now gives me pleasure to hand over the award to Professor Sadgopal. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Subramaniam. Now we are all eagerly looking forward to the public lecture that Professor Sadgopal will be delivering today. It's titled, as you can see here, Hoshangabad Vidyan in Government Schools, Dismantling Hegemonies and Reconstructing Discourse. But one of my tasks is that I have to introduce the speaker who actually does not need any introduction. But I mentioned earlier that I'll talk about this auditorium, that I'm very happy that this is taking place in the auditorium, which is Viji Kulkarni Memorial Auditorium. As both Professor Anil Sadgopal and Viji Kulkarni were friends and perhaps inspirations. And this association led to the genesis of a Homi Bhabha Center for Science Education and perhaps all of us, our presence here today. So briefly, giving us introduction to Professor Anil Sadgopal. He has a PhD in biochemistry and molecular biology in 1968 from California Institute of Technology, USA. He was a fellow at the TIFR from 1968 to 71. And at the age of 31, he resigned from TIFR to organize a rural education and development program through Kishore Bharti in the Hoshangabad district of Madhya Pradesh, where he was active from 1971 to 1992. In collaboration with the Friends Rural Center Rasulia, we'll hear all about this in his talk, of course. He initiated the Hoshangabad Science Teaching Program, which is called HSTP, in 1972, and the details of it will all be apparent to us. What is important is that, Professor Anil Sadgopal is a very good mix of an academic and an activist. He joined the People's Science Movement and the Movement for Civil Liberties in the early 80s, and he was very active in the struggle of the Bhopal gas victims against Union Carbide. For all those who are very young, perhaps they should try to remember this event. And he was then, because of his efforts in getting medical treatment and rehabilitation from the government, he was appointed by the Supreme Court on the committee to recommend measures for the Bhopal gas victims and for their rehabilitation. This was from 1986 to 88. He was the national convener of the Bharat Jan Vidyan Jatha, BJVJ, and All India People Science Network till 2002. And he conceived and led the BJVJ's Lokshala program for demonstrating an alternative vision of universalization of elementary education. So I mentioned that he's a perfect combination of academic and activist. So at a later age, in 1994, he became a professor of education in the University of Delhi, served as the head and in the Department of Education, and was the Dean Faculty of Education from 1998 to 2001. He has also been a senior fellow at the Nehru Memorial Museum and Library. He has been a member on various national commissions on teachers, that is 1983 to 84, the National Policy on Education Review Committee, or as it's also known, the Acharya Ramamurthy Committee. He was on the Central Advisory Board of Education from 2004 to 2006, and mainly on three committees. One is on Free and Compulsory Education Bill, the Girls Education and Common School System, and the universalization of secondary education. He was on the National Steering Committee for Review of the NCF, National Curriculum Framework, NCRT. He was the chairman of the National Focus Group on Work and Education for the NCF. And he has been the recipient of awards like the Jamnalal Bajaj Award in 1980 and Shanti Niketan's Ratindra Puraskar in 1984 for application of science and technology to rural areas. And as you now know of the Homi Bhabha Award in Science Education. He has authored numerous books and articles in Hindi and English, and is the founder, member, and presidium of the All India Forum for Right to Education. And as a result of his interventions, he has acquired a public image as a radical educationist, or as is also known as the Vidrohi Shikshavid. So I invite Professor Anil Sadgopal to now give his public lecture and talk. Thank you.
Professor Subramaniam, Professor Sugra Chunawala, because they both communicated with me in the last several weeks to reach here, and all the former directors of Homi Bhabha Center for Science Education and the former awardees. I salute you all along with my cordial wishes and thanks to all everybody in the audience who have taken the trouble to travel through Mumbai traffic and reach here to listen to me. I hope it will be worth it, your entire effort to reach here. I begin with a sense of reluctance and self-doubt. The reason is that awards normally in our country are being given to individuals, while the entire effort is always a collective effort, invariably. I expressed this doubt to some friends through emails in the last few days. The how can one person like me represent the Hoshangabad science teaching program, which was a massive effort involving not the dozens of people, but literally hundreds and thousands of people at various stages of his growth and evolution. So one of my major challenge today would be, while talking about the story of HSTP, is to keep sharing with you the various names which will pop up in my mind. But I am also very doubtful about taking that exercise seriously, because I know while doing it, I'm likely to miss many names. So when I'm really in a dilemma. If I don't mention the names, then it will look like as if a person like me has done a single-handed effort, which is impossible, cannot happen. If I mention them, I'm likely to miss out on many important names. But I'll try to do as much justice to this important responsibility as possible for me. I begin with the story of 1969, when I had spent hardly a year in TIFR. When I get a call from late Professor Yashpal, asking me to come down from molecular biology unit to the West Canteen, where people met to talk about their areas of interest. So I went down and I was introduced to Mr. B.G. Pitre, who had come from Dehradun, from a school, well-known school, reputed or not, I do not know, but a well-known school called Dune School. He had come as a physics teacher from there. And another person whom I had seen on the campus but never been introduced properly was Professor V.G. Kulkarni, 1969. The three of us sat together, had a cup of coffee, a long chat about the reason why Pitreji was invited by Professor Yashpal. Pitreji and two other teachers like him, working in some, within quotation marks, public schools, they are not actually public schools, they are highly privatized schools, not meant for public of India, but they are called public schools. These three teachers had a dedication to evolve a program of teaching science through experiments. Since all the three of them were physics teachers, they started with a focus on teaching physics through experiments. This must have been in mid-60s to 68, the period when they developed a book by evolving experiments called Physics Through Experiments. And Pitreji was a better known person amongst the three. And so he was invited. So after Mr. Pitre had shared his experiences, then Professor Yashpal and Professor Kulkarni, who had a prior consultation, informed the two of us that they are already involved, along with many other scientists of TIFR, in visiting the Marathi medium, sometime Marwadi medium or Hindi medium, Telugu and Tamil medium. BMC, Bombay Municipal Corporation, has been amazing in having multilingual program of schooling. So they had been visiting these schools with experiments devised by them, showing the experiment, exciting the imagination of students in their whatever time they could take out of their research. And this was already being encouraged by the then director, Professor Menon. But now the things had reached at a little higher level when Professor Yashpal and Professor Kulkarni was talking about intervening in four Marathi medium schools where they will introduce learning of science, not just physics, all aspects of science, from class 5, where the first year of the upper primary begins. It used to begin, I think even now it has not changed, from class 5 up to class 7. So a lot of early preparation had been done. This was all shared with Mr. Pitre. Then Mr. Pitre was requested to guide them further, because he had the experience of doing such things. He agreed, and a date was settled a couple of months later when Mr. Pitre will come, and about 60 teachers from four schools would be invited with permission of the Bombay Municipal Corporation Education Department. This happened. I have many stories to tell, so I'm going to hurry up and not share the details with you. Each detail is an exciting detail, at least in my memory, but I won't spend time on all the details. I remember when the first teacher interaction took place in Bombay Municipal Corporation from TIFR initiative. There's a large lecture hall on the ground floor, and I was invited, but I wanted to keep a distance. I must quickly share the reason for distance. I kept a distance because I had already decided to quit TIFR after completing 3 years, and this is, I'm talking of 1970, when the time was coming closer, because 71 December I quit. So I wanted to keep a distance because I was quitting TIFR and moving to Madhya Pradesh. The place was not settled, but somewhere in Madhya Pradesh, not to do science education at all. That was the farthest thing in my mind. This is the first time I'm acknowledging this in a public meeting. In other personal meetings and informal meetings, I have not only acknowledged, I've written about it also somewhere. The first time I'm acknowledging that it was the farthest thing in my mind to go to Madhya Pradesh villages and do any work in science education. So what was I going for? I was going there to start a program of Nayi Taleem inspired by Gandhi. At that time, whatever little understanding I had, since then I have read a lot, studied and analyzed, written a lot on this subject. But Nayi Taleem was my Zunoon, if that word makes sense to you. Literally a Zunoon for me. With this Zunoon, I didn't want to distract my attention, emotional or intellectual, to start listening to what happens in science education. So I refused to enter the lecture hall. I stood outside on the door and I said, for a few minutes I will listen and then go away. But I stood at the door for next 1 hour. Bhaskar Pitre came into the hall and started with an experiment. A long table that I think is still there, that long table of 1970. The long table stood behind it with a 1 meter long scale. And it's very important because that became almost the guiding spirit of Hoshangabad science teaching program later and of any important science education intervention. So long table, and Mr. Pitre says, he was a Marathi speaking teacher, so he says in Marathi to the teachers that we will today measure the table. Each one of you would be invited to measure the table. It's a slip of paper to record your length which you measured, and when you all finish, then we'll open the slip and write on the blackboard the length which you have measured. So some people laughed also, what is this? We are senior teachers, experienced teachers in science, and we are being asked to measure a table. But they reluctantly agreed. So they measured one by one, 60 measurements came. And the 60 measurements were written on the blackboard. And there was no identical measurement, each one was different. Ranging from, let's say the table was 3 meters long, then ranging from 2.8 meters to maybe 3.8 meters. So the natural question asked by Bhaskar Pitre was to them, do you think the table is changing its length or the meter scale is changing its length? What is happening? What is changing? Why are you not able to get identical or nearly identical measurements? So teacher said, look, we did not take you seriously. We thought you were just mocking us at us by saying measure. Now give us a second chance, we'll be very careful. So second chance was given, and again the measurements varied. But this time the variation was less than the first attempt. Then a third attempt was done. Still there is a variation, considerable variation, but much less than the previous two attempts. The teachers were aghast. So look, we are so serious about measuring it. Now it was a challenge for them. And we are not able to get the same measurement. So Bhaskar Pitre joked, I told you earlier, the meter scale must be changing its length. Maybe the table is getting longer and shorter while you're measuring. Something is wrong. And then this beautiful experiment, which has been repeated hundreds of times in Hoshangabad teaching program, Hoshangabad science teaching program, and then later on outside the district also, and in Rajasthan, Gujarat also, in some schools. I mean, repeated in every teacher training program is as exciting as it was in 1970 when I was watching the experiments being done from outside the lecture hall. Finally, analysis took place and it was worked out. I won't repeat this story because this is only, it can be told only once. So Bhaskar Pitre told them, whenever a measurement is made, whether of length or of weight or of area or surface area, whatever measurement we do, there's invariably a variation. Then teachers asked, are you saying there's not a fixed length of a table? I said, no, I did not say it. I said that measurement varies and it's almost impossible to measure the exact length of the table. It will always be a statistical variation, use the word. It will be variation. So we can talk about the variation. And the mean can be taken and then plus minus so many centimeters. That's all we can do. Of course, when it happened in Hoshangabad, in the very first workshop, a couple of years later in May 1972, then students, teachers asked some more fundamental questions. I do not know whether it is because of the water of Narmada or not. I do not know. They asked, after doing this experiment in the very first workshop in May 1972, being watched and guided by Professor Yashpal himself, they said, are you saying there is no truth in science? Kya vigyan mein koi shashwat satya nahi hota hai? And this time Bhaskar Pitre wasn't there. So Professor Yashpal said, you're right. There is no shashwat satya in science. Satya varies and is relative satya. Our job is to keep engaging ourselves in search of truth. And we'll spend our whole life, and you'll spend your whole life in your schools now, in searching for truth along with the students. Amazing message given by Professor Yashpa. And similar message from Bhaskar Pitre 2 years earlier. I walked away with a sense of almost shock that this can be done and conveyed in this very simple manner. But then I knocked at my head, no, don't get swayed away. Your job is to go to some place in Madhya Pradesh and work on Nai Talim. You can incorporate this experiment in Nai Talim. There's plenty of scope for that, but Nai Talim is a goal. So I went back to my Nai Talim project. And eventually, to cut the long story short, with help of the then leadership of Friend Rural Center Rasulia. Rasulia is a village at that time 1 kilometer out of Hoshangabad town, now inside the Hoshangabad town, as it has happened all over the country. So that person called Sudarshan Kapoor, whose name is not remembered in the history of HSTP, but it's my duty to record his name. And I wrote to him when he congratulated me for the award. He's not in India anymore. He's teaching Buddhism in Colorado University. So he wrote to me a few days ago that, look, I'm very happy you got it. And I know you've never given up the cause of better education in schools. Please continue. So I wrote back to him, why are you dissociating yourself from this? I happen to be here, so I'm going to accept the award. But don't you know that if you were not around, there would have been no HSTP. If there was no HSTP, there would have been no Homi Bhabha Center for Science Education. If there was no Homi Bhabha Center, there would have been no award. So he wrote back very nicely. He said, look, I was only a fighter on the front line, but the core guidance came from you. So don't forget that. The core spirit is yours. I was only protecting the boundaries and expanding the boundaries. He's right also. So Sudarshan was at Rasulia, and Rasulia was going through a very bad phase. Rasulia Center established in 1860 by some Quakers from Australia and Canada, because there was a famine and they came to India to help in famine, rehabilitation. So they set up this institution called Friends Rural Center Rasulia. So Rasulia was going through a bad phase because it was looking for a meaningful direction. So they were running a school on the campus whose signboard said Bunyadi Shala, then below that Nai Talim. So Sudarshan told me, go to that school and tell me whether any Nai Talim is going on or not, because you're going to do it yourself. So I reported back to him, there's not a sign of Nai Talim in that school. It runs like any other school in the country. Then the chairperson of the governing body of that center happens to be a very formidable person in the history of Nai Talim, called Marjorie Sykes, a close friend of Gandhi. And she was inspired by Gandhi to do Nai Talim work in central India, Vidarbha area, as well as the Bhopal region. So the same task was given by Marjorie to me, and I reported back to her the same report that there's no Nai Talim happening in your school. Then both of them asked me, then why should we continue to school if nothing new is happening? Our job is to change. If no change is happening because of that school, let us close it down. Then they asked me, is there any idea in your mind which can bring about a change in the government school system? Give it a new life, new vision? I said, look, I don't know. I've not applied my mind to it. And I said, look, my job is to start a Nai Talim school. So I'm not talking about how to improve government schools. And they insisted upon an idea and mentioned Bhaskar Pitre as a colleague. So Bhaskar Pitre came and he again talked about his work and how he has done. Everybody at the Rasulia Center was inspired. And Bhaskar Pitre said, look, I'm too old to do anything, but if you really want this to go forward, catch hold of Anil. Don't let him go away to his Nai Talim. So Sudarshan, being very smart, not in the modern sense of with a computer and a mobile, but without that he was very smart in ideas, and he caught hold of me. He said, you have to help us. You can go and do what you want to do. Then he found out that I'm not moving an inch from my resolve. So he said to me, what do you want to do? You want to run one Nai Talim school, you'll be remembered headmaster of a good school. Is that the end of your life? Is that why you have come all the way from Bombay, quitting TIFR? Why have you quit? Just for being a good headmaster of a good school. Then I realized he was talking about transformation of the entire education system. So I promise, I will stand by you, I'll help, but I will not get involved formally, officially into it. This was agreement between us. And the story started from there. We heard that there is a young IITian in Kanpur, IIT Kanpur, who just finished his M.Tech in chemistry, and looking for some place where science education is being reviewed and redefined. He heard about Rasulia, he came to meet us. His name is Rashid Sheikh. And Rashid got very excited. He wrote a 4-page proposal to the government of Madhya Pradesh in Hindi, because government read only Hindi at that time. So a Hindi report, 4-page proposal, that this is why this kind of science has to be done, which will wipe out the pedagogy of rote learning, memorization, and replace it by critical thinking, scientific thought, scientific method, and all that. And with Rashid, Sudarsh and I took a trip to Bhopal. A very interesting story. I want to cut it short again. When did I start? I started at 4 o'clock, roughly. Okay. We took an appointment with the then director of public instruction, that was the name, official name from the British days, of the education office of the state governments. The then director of public instruction was Dr. B.D. Sharma, a PhD in mathematics, IAS officer, who's known not for being an IAS officer, not for having mathematics as his PhD topic. He's known because he organized scheduled tribes, the tribals of India all over the country, and fought for liberating them from alienation from their land, from their forest, and from oppression, exploitation. And he became later on Scheduled Caste, Scheduled Tribe Commissioner of India, which is a statutory post in the Constitution, and wrote two excellent, powerful reports, which have been thrown in the waste paper basket as expected. So that Dr. B.D. Sharma in younger days was sitting at the chair of DPI. He looked at the 4-page report quickly and said, I'm willing to consider this. Give me a week's time. I'll call you again. We thought this is the end of the story. We'll never be called again. Like any bureaucrat, he has shunted us out. But 1 week later, we got a phone call from the DEO office in Hoshangabad, District Education Officer, Jila Shiksha Adhikari, saying that director wants to meet you immediately tomorrow. Come, go there. Reach in the evening, meet him tomorrow morning. We met him. This time he was not alone. This time about 20 people were sitting behind his swivel chair. We were introduced that they are all members of Department of Education holding different positions, from assistant director to joint director to science consultant, mathematics consultant, and the additional director, the executive head. So he told them, you all read the report, proposal given by them. I want you to react and give your views to these people. You were all ready. First, the NCRT representative sitting there was asked. We did not know that NCRT has got ambassadors sitting in different parts of India. That was the first time we came to know. We were told he's like an ambassador for Western India, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Gujarat, and Goa. So he was asked to speak before the department people. He said, this report should be thrown out of the window because NCRT has thought about this subject a lot. He's talking in 1971 and or early 72. In 60s, NCRT decided learning science through experiments is a luxury for the rich countries of Europe and America. This is not something which is meant for poor countries like India. Secondly, it is impossible to learn science through experiment because it's a very difficult thing, and even North American countries and even European countries have not really succeeded, and we should not get into it at all. So as representative of NCRT, I advise you not to listen to them. Then the rest of the people were ready, even more ready than the NCRT person. And one of them, the senior most, said, can I question these people? Ask some question. So yes, you can ask, DPI told him. So he asked me, he thought maybe I was introduced as a former scientist from TIFR. So he asked me, do you have a B.Ed. degree? And I'll be honest with you, I said, what is B.Ed.? A different matter that decades later I headed the Department of Education, Delhi University, and presided over B.Ed., M.Ed., M.Phil., Ph.D.s in education. That is a different story. I said, what is B.Ed.? An honest question. Rashid sitting next to me was pulling my kurta. I said, stop, don't say that. Then he asked, have you ever taught in a school? I said, no. He said, sir, I told you, they are amateurs. Then he said, have you taught anyone ever? I said, before going to US, I used to teach children studying in class 6, 7, something about science before leaving for Caltech, which I did in my neighborhood. He said, look, totally inexperienced, doesn't know ABC of education theory, and he wants to come here and change the destiny of our schools. How can he do it? Don't allow him. And one after another, about 10 more people added the same kind of narrative. A old person, little older person, sitting at the back, he was quiet. So Dr. Sharma looked at him and said, Sevaramji, do you want to say anything? Kuch aapko kehna hai? He said, yes, I'm waiting for my turn. He stood up and said, I've read the report, put my notes on the margin, I've given a photocopy to you. I hope you've read it. This report should be, proposal should be immediately accepted and implemented. He said, I have served as science consultant of the Department of Education for the last 30 years. I never see a proposal of this kind. So beautifully written, so crystal clear in the ideas, with a resolve to end rote learning in science and replace it with critical thinking, scientific thought, and experiments. Please allow them. Amazing, a science consultant, very junior. At that time, his position was like assistant director at that level. There were two other higher positions before DPI, between him and the DPI. He took this courage to say that. And he carried a choti. So years later, when he got involved with us, he used to come to our campus of Keshav Bharati or Rasulia for teacher education programs with his choti. And he used to be very apologetic. He said, please forgive me. I am a student of science. I understand logic, rationality, and all that. I'm all in favor of it. You know it. But I somehow cannot get rid of this choti. Please tolerate me with the choti. Just apology right in advance. Disclaimer. A wonderful person. One of the makers of HSTP. So Dr. Sharma was ready with a written letter, official letter, in response to our proposal. So he looked back at us, turned his swivel chair, and said, permission is granted. Aapko izazat di jati hai. There was a huge human cry in the room. How can he do, sir? Kya kar rahe hain aap? Barbaad kar denge Madhya Pradesh ki shiksha ko. So his answer is historical answer. He said, Madhya Pradesh ki schoolon ki halat itni badhal ho chuki hai, isko ye aur kitna bigadenge. Then he said to us in more serious tone, there are three conditions on which I am giving you permission. Number one, you shall not change the syllabus. At that time, I did not know the difference between syllabus and curriculum. If I don't, I would have immediately pointed out, we'll change the curriculum. We'll not change the curriculum, but we'll change the syllabus. But again, Rashid stopped me from saying that. But I did not know the difference at that time. Now I do. Second, you shall never ask for change in the examination system. Say, okay. We are doubtful, but we said, okay. Third, you'll never ask for any money from the state government. He said, this I want to explain to you, because this is not an educational matter, this is a political matter. He said, state government gives money when a budget is approved in the Vidhan Sabha. If you ask for any money, the budget will have to provide for that money in the Vidhan Sabha. In Vidhan Sabha, there will be politicians who will throw out your entire proposal. So save yourself from going to Vidhan Sabha, don't ask for money. Manage your money if somehow you can manage. On these three conditions, permission was granted. Next morning, we got a call in Hoshangabad from the same DEO, Jilla Shiksha Adhikari, saying that I've received the official letter saying that select schools for the program. So would you come along with me? So Rasulia had a jeep, we took out the jeep, and DEO did not have a jeep, so we took him along. We visited Hoshangabad block, more than 100 villages in that area, and Sudarshan insisted that Kishore Bharati campus, recently established them, was in Bankhedi block, 100 kilometers away, more than 100 kilometers away. So he wanted some schools in Bankhedi block. His calculation was, if Bankhedi block schools are included, Anil will not be walk out of the program. He'll be committed because of his location. I understood it, but there was no way out. So 9 schools in Hoshangabad block and 7 schools in Bankhedi block was selected in 1972, early 1972. In fact, only 15, permission was given only for 15 schools. So when the 7th school was added in a remote tribal village, I asked the DEO, how can you add a 16th school? Because permission, written permission is only for 15. He said, look, they have given me a letter saying that such a radical idea of science education called HSTP is being allowed. When they can take such a radical decision as DEO of the district, at least I can take the courage of adding one school. I'll not consult the DPI for this. There's no need. He added a school. I'm giving you examples after example how people moved beyond their official mandates and took decisions one after another, opening new spaces for us. With 16 schools, the program was announced in May 1972, the first teacher education workshop took place. One of the most exciting thing which has happened in my lifetime. We keep calling it a teacher education workshop, not teacher training workshop. It's because you train dogs and cats, you don't train human beings. I know all over the country they use the word teacher training. So we call it teacher education, and you'll shortly know why it is so important not to call it training, but to call it teacher education. I just want some water. Professor Yashpal was there, a team of young scientists from TIFR, led by Ramu Ganguly, if that name is familiar to you. Dinesh Sharma, I do not know if Dinesh is sitting here or not. I sent a message that he should come. Thank you. Dinesh Sharma and 3 or 4 other people, I don't recall the names. They had come to join our workshop as chemistry people. They'll add chemistry. Physics they added from Pitre's group. And biology was my headache. So all the 3 major dimensions will be added. Geology was still not included because we did not know whom to ask to help. So some short stories about that. On the very first day of the workshop, 40 teachers invited from 16 schools. were introduced to the idea of conducting experiments. Not one of them had ever conducted an experiment. Nothing surprising. They're not conducting an experiment. Two-thirds of them had studied science only up to high school. They're not gone beyond high school in their life, so they studied science up to high school. One-third of them had studied up to either up to 12th class or first couple of years or 3 years of BSc, but that was maybe only one out of them was a BSc degree holder. But not one of them had ever conducted an experiment. It is not surprising, very much as expected. So they were divided into groups of four, around 10 tables, and they started doing experiments. As they were doing experiments, they got involved in what they were doing. They got a little bit excited, stimulated by their experience of doing the experiment. So they started discussing what is happening in experiment, what observations are being made, what kind of data is emerging, among themselves discussing, and gradually the discussion became very excited. And they started discussing with each other, what color is your experiment showing, what color is your experiment showing, mine is different, yours is different, what is happening, science is giving different results. They all started discussing. There was a lot of noise in the room. At that time, DO had not arrived in the right time, and he came on his bicycle, and teacher saw his bicycle coming towards us through the window. And the teacher said, "Arre, Jila Shiksha Adhikari sahab aa rahe hain, DO sahab aa rahe hain. Chup, chup, chup." Suddenly there was a pin drop silence. Not a word came out. He said, "Look, continue what you are talking. Any DO sahab aa rahe hain. Aapko nahi malum." The DO sahab arrived. He had heard the noise from the window. He knew what was happening. So when he arrived, he put his bicycle outside and he walked in. And many teachers got up to salute him. And some teachers vacated their chair. "Please, sahab, aage aaiye." He said, "No, you please continue what you're doing. I have heard about what is going to happen here. I know. You please continue engagement." So they quietly started continue the experiments again. But not one voice will come out of them. Then DO said, "Aap logon ne baat karna kyun band kar diya?" Pin drop silence. Then he provoked them. "Jab mere gair hazri mein baatcheet ho sakti hai aapas mein, to mere hazri mein kya dikkat hai? Nahi sahab, aapke samne kaise bol rahe? Humne aaj tak kabhi bola aapke samne? Hum to muh nahi kholte aapke samne." So he was very nice. He stood up and said, "I'll visit each one of you and see what is happening." He went to all the tables, and gradually they had the courage to start talking again. Over the time, the equation had totally changed. It did not matter it was district education officer coming to visit them, or the divisional officer of the five or six districts in a commissary, or it is a DPI coming, or the secretary education coming. Each one had to sit down on the floor on a dari and engage in discussion, debate, dialogue with the teachers, and teachers had to respond. Teachers could question the secretary education. It happened within the next 5-6 years. That whole authority of the authorities was eroded by the science teaching program. That was one of the greatest success I will record. Because if that had not been done, no education leading the children to scientific thinking, scientific methodology could ever take roots in Hoshangabad without challenging the authority and establishing a sense of equality amongst the partners in the program. And everybody is a partner. This idea was communicated. Second day was even more dangerous. Professor Yashpal was guiding, and some experiment had been conducted by the teachers, and many questions were being raised. By this time, by second day, they were getting used to asking questions. Many questions were being raised. At some stage, Professor Yashpal said, "Ye to bahut mushkil sawal pooch liya aapne. Iska jawab to mere paas nahi hai." I hope everyone understands this much of Hindi. "Mere paas nahi hai jawab. Mujhe sochne ka time dijiye. Aur ye jo hamare saathi yahan hain, inse main shaam ko baat karunga. Raat ko hum charcha karenge. Kal denge jawab." One teacher stood up and said, "Sir, क्या बात करी आपने, आप जैसा वैज्ञानिक जो दुनिया भर में जाना जाता है, जब उसको जवाब नहीं आता तो आप सोचिए हमारी हालत क्या होगी स्कूलों में। वहाँ बच्चे तो ऐसा प्रयोग करने के बाद तमाम उल जलूल सवाल पूछेंगे। उल जलूल मीन्स इररेलेवेंट, फुलिश। वो उल जलूल सवाल पूछेंगे तो हम क्या करेंगे? हम भी बोलेंगे हमको नहीं आता, कल बताएंगे। उसे यशपाल से यस विल डू एग्जैक्टली दिस इफ यू डू नॉट नो, व्हाट एल्स विल यू डू? अगर नहीं जानते तो बोलना पड़ेगा ना कि नहीं जानते। कोई भी इंसान दुनिया में नहीं है जिसके पास सारा ज्ञान होता है। नो ह्यूमन बींग हैज द एंटायर नॉलेज ऑफ द यूनिवर्स। तो इसमें क्या गलत बात है? नहीं है, मेनी टीचर्स स्टूड अप, नो दिस इज नॉट पॉसिबल, वी कैन नॉट डू दिस इन द स्कूल, ऑन दिस ग्राउंड वी रिफ्यूज टू बी पार्ट ऑफ द प्रोग्राम। व्हाई, व्हाट इज रॉन्ग इन सेइंग आई डू नॉट नो? यशपाल जी सर, आई से आई डू नॉट नो इवन इन इंटरनेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस। से आप कह सकते हैं, हम नहीं कह सकते। क्यों नहीं कह सकते? दे गेव ए वेरी अमेजिंग आंसर। आंसर वॉज बिकॉज इन स्कूल्स स्टूडेंट्स कंसिडर ईच टीचर टू बी द अल्टीमेट सोर्स ऑफ नॉलेज, ज्ञान का अंतिम स्रोत होते हैं। एंड बिकॉज वी आर कंसिडर्ड अल्टीमेट सोर्स ऑफ नॉलेज, it is from this conception that our authority flows into the school system. Satta ka sawal hai, isse satta nikalti hai hamari, and because of that authority we hold over the entire school, we are able to command discipline from every student. If we say we do not know, we lose the command over discipline of the school. To hamari authority ka kya hoga, hamari satta ka kya hoga? और फिर हम अनुशासन कैसे लाएंगे? आई न्यू इट वॉज ए ब्राह्मणिकल माइंड सेट स्पीकिंग, वी ऑल न्यू दैट। इट्स डिफरेंट मैटर वेदर दे वर ब्राह्मण्स और नॉट, मोस्ट ऑफ द वर फ्रॉम अपर कास्ट, दे वर नॉट ए सिंगल दलित एट दैट टाइम बिकॉज रिजर्वेशन एजेंडा वॉज वेरी वीक इन दोज ईयर्स, सो सोशल जस्टिस वॉज ए ऑन द बैक सीट, सो नो ट्राइबल, रेयरली यू फाइंड ए ट्राइबल टीचर और ए दलित टीचर, सो रेस्ट ऑफ दम वर फ्रॉम अपर कास्ट। So I knew it was a Brahminical mindset speaking. So we had to engage with it. So a lot of discussion took place on that day. No more experiment was done. Not a single more experiment was conducted. Discussion was about the relationship, assumed, presumed relationship between knowledge and authority, and between authority and whatever they think is a notion of discipline, whatever is their notion of discipline. They were unconvinced. ठीक है, आपका बात सुन लिया, पर हम करेंगे वही जो हमको करना है। अगर डीओ साहब ने कहा यही प्रोग्राम करना है तो करेंगे, करना पड़ेगा, लेकिन हम एक्सपेरिमेंट ऐसा नहीं करेंगे जहां इतने सारे सवाल उठते हैं। आफ्टर 7 days ऑफ वर्कशॉप दे स्टॉप सेइंग इट, इट्स अ डिफरेंट मैटर बिकॉज दे लर्न अ डिफरेंट कल्चर, दे बिकॉज दे बिकेम पार्ट ऑफ ए न्यू कल्चर ऑफ साइंस एंड डेमोक्रेसी। वेरी एक्साइटिंग। थर्ड डे वॉज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग, evening before that, on the evening of second day, we got a telephone call from our great DEO. There is a very strange message from the capital that tomorrow the education minister returning from his hometown in Sidhi on the eastern part of Madhya Pradesh, touching UP, from his hometown via Itarsi, because Itarsi was the link to go to Bhopal by train, and on his way he wants to stop by and spend some time in the HSTP workshop. हमने कहा आपको गलती लगा होगा। नहीं नहीं, पक्का मैसेज है। So we didn't announce, but next morning we told the teachers, sometime before lunch the education minister will arrive. तो साहब फूलों का गुलदस्ता है कि नहीं है? वो तो नहीं है, तो ले आते हैं हम, आप हम वहाँ पर अपने पैसे ले आएंगे। अरे शिक्षा मंत्री कभी नहीं आते, वो कैसे आ रहे हैं यहाँ पे? ले आते हैं। काम डाउन, जस्ट कंटिन्यू व्हाट यू आर डूइंग। ऑन दैट डे दे वर यूजिंग मैग्नेट एंड लर्निंग हाउ मैग्नेट बिहेव्स, एक्सपेरिमेंट विद मैग्नेट्स। मैं आपको इतना मज़ा आ रहा था मैग्नेट को इस्तेमाल करते हुए, तो आप करते रहिए। नहीं साहब, शिक्षा मंत्री वो तो बड़ी भारी बात है, वो डीओ थोड़ी ना है, उनके साथ तो पुलिस आएगी, आईजी पुलिस होगा, पता नहीं क्या क्या होगा, वो तो बहुत बड़ा मामला है, तैयारी कीजिए। मैंने कहा कोई तैयारी नहीं की जाएगी, कुछ नहीं होगा, जब आएंगे, जैसे डीओ साहब ने एक्सपेरिमेंट किया आपके साथ बैठ के, मंत्री जी भी आपके साथ बैठ के एक्सपेरिमेंट ही करेंगे, और कुछ नहीं, उनका भाषण, उनका कोई भाषण नहीं होगा. वी आर अटैकिंग, वी आर क्वेश्चनिंग द होल पॉलिटिकल कल्चर ऑन द वेरी थर्ड डे ऑफ द वर्कशॉप. ही केम, ऑफ कोर्स सेवरल कार्स बिहाइंड हिम, पुलिस एंड ऑल दैट, नेचुरली वी केप्ट एवरीबॉडी अवे. ही केम अलोन, वॉकड इन, एवरीबडी स्टूड अप, बैठ जाइए, आराम से बैठ जाइए. मैंने सुना कि आज आप लोग, डीओ ने बता दिया था, आज आप चुंबक के साथ काम कर रहे हैं. मैंने तो कभी चुंबक को हाथ भी नहीं लगाया, मैं भी आपके साथ प्रयोग करूंगा और चुंबक का काम देखूंगा. चुंबक इज मैग्नेट. देन ही एक्चुअली सेट डाउन एंड टीचर्स वेट बैक, पुल देयर चेयर्स बैक, दे वर फ्राइटेंड. मिनिस्टर सिटिंग नेक्स्ट टू देम, नेक्स्ट टू इन द सेम टेबल एंड सेइंग, चुंबक कहाँ है दिखाओ. But they somehow settled down, and for next half an hour, the Minister of Education, Madhya Pradesh, conducted experiments with them. Then he said, it's time for me to leave. And he got up and said, I convey my best wishes to this new initiative. I pay my respects to Professor Yashpal. He knew him by name. I'm very happy I met him. I thank all the young people here. Please continue the good work. And whenever you require any help, just give me a message. Help will come from education department. He went away. He was not wrong about his promise of help. We never asked for any help until a year passed away. In 73, 31st March, the same DO calls us, says, can I come? Are you people around? He said, yes, you can come. So he came on his bicycle. His famous bicycle is very important in my imagery. He came on his bicycle with a small bag hanging and opened the bag and said, here is a envelope for you from Education Minister. 31st March of 73, we opened the envelope. There was a covering letter, official covering letter, not by him, by his office, saying that the Education Department in Hindi, Shiksha Vibhag ko bahut khushi hai, aap logon ke achhe Hoshangabad Vigyan Shikshan Karyakram ke liye, आपको 10,000 रुपए का अनुदान देते हुए, 10,000 रुपीज ग्रांट. वी नेवर आस्क्ड फॉर इट. सो सुदर्शन सेड, रिटर्न इट, गिव इट बैक. एंड वी हैव प्रॉमिस्ड बीडी शर्मा नॉट टू टेक एनी मनी फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट. सो हमने कहा, डीओ साहब, इसको तो वापस ले जाइए आप. अरे क्यों? हमने तो एप्लीकेशन भी नहीं लगाया. देखिए, मुझे नहीं मालूम एप्लीकेशन लगाया नहीं लगाया, मेरा काम है 31st मार्च के पहले आपको देना और आपको बैंक में डालना आज ही, नहीं तो फाइनेंशियल ईयर बदल जाएगा. आपको मालूम है फाइनेंशियल ईयर क्या होता है? हमने कहा मालूम है, तो वो बदल जाएगा, इसलिए कल नहीं आज डालना, और नहीं डाला तो एजुकेशन मिनिस्टर मुझको ट्रांसफर करवा देंगे यहाँ से, और मुझे अभी आपके साथ रहना है यहाँ पे, तो प्लीज इसको ले लीजिए और यहाँ पे साइन कर दीजिए, आपको मिल गया. Since the program was being run by Friends Rural Center Rasulia, not by Kishore Bharati, Sudarshan signed and put a stamp and gave it to him, and we got a check. I don't think any of us ever heard of such a story. Minister sends a check insisting whether you apply or not, you take it. So this is a new culture of Hoshangabad program developing there. I will not take more time on the very first workshop. I want to move forward. Program started from month of July in the schools. It was decided in the workshop that we'll have a program of monthly meeting. We'll all meet once a month for follow-up, any problems, any new ideas, anything to be done, to problems to be resolved. And we will visit you continuously. We'll come to your schools, 16 schools. So Sudarshan took responsibility for Hoshangabad block. I took responsibility for Bankheri block. We started going to schools on bicycles. That's the only mode of transport. And recording our diaries, maintaining diaries, getting involved with the teachers and the children with any problem. Invariably, there were problems after problems of conducting experiments, but those were being resolved. By this time, we had prepared a science kit, which at that time cost us 500 rupees per school for conducting planned 300 plus experiments in three classes with children sitting in groups of four each, often on kacha classroom floor with cow dung covered floor, and conducting modern scientific experiments. For that purpose, we provided a kit. At that time, it cost us 500 rupees per school. On the very first meeting, one teacher got up, monthly meeting, and said, we are enjoying, we are having great fun. We never had such a fun in our schools. Even village people are coming to the school, parents are coming, watching what is happening. Everybody is excited about what is happening. But we will do everything in this program except taking out field trips. Apart from experiments being an important source of learning, field trip was another important source of learning. Children will go out in the farms or on the rocks nearby, collect stones or parts of various crops, bring them into the material, will be brought into classroom, and next day there will be a study of the material. Classifying flowers, you know, dissecting flowers, even taking out ovaries from there, which none of them had ever done. It's all very exciting. This was field trip. We'll not do it anymore. We kyun nahi karenge? Maza nahi aata? Nahi, maza to bahut aata hai. Bahut mast hai mamla. Lekin karenge nahi. Kyun nahi karenge? Ab last time jo hum le gaye na pichle hafte, to sari class aur main hum sab bahar the ek ghante ke liye. To saab piche jante hain kya hua? School inspector saab aa gaye. Unhone dekha class khali hai. Unhone headmaster ko bulaya. Mera naam leke bola, unka naam leke bola, unki CR file lao, confidential report file lao. Hamari CR file pe unhone note kiya ki jab main yahan aaya tha to puri class khali thi aur teacher bhi gayab tha. To sab aise to nahi chalega, mera to promotion ruk jayega, mera increment due hai. Mujhe apne bachchon ki shaadi karni hai to increment bhi nahi milega. Main to barbaad ho jaunga, main nahi karunga aur baki se maine pooch liya, sab keh rahe hain mana kar do. बाकी सब ठीक है. सो वी कॉल्ड अवर डीओ, अवर संकट मोचक हनुमान. सो ही केम इमीडिएटली ऑन हिज बाइसिकल बट फ्रॉम 2 किलोमीटर डिस्टेंस. इनसे क्या बात है, क्यों घबराए हुए आप लोग? सो ही हर्ड द होल स्टोरी. ही सेड दिस इज सीरियस, आई अंडरस्टैंड दैट दिस विल डिस्ट्रॉय द प्रोग्राम. आई डू नॉट नो हाउ ही ऑन हिज ओन फिगर्ड आउट व्हाट इज द कोर स्पिरिट ऑफ द प्रोग्राम. Because we spend a lot of time with him, of course, explaining why we are doing what we are going to do. So he said, I understand this cannot go on, but give me 2 days' time, I'll solve this problem. So 2 days later, he issued an official order on a plain paper, typed in Hindi in very bad typing. All typewriters were in bad shape. He typed that order. It's called demi-official order, DO. So that order said in 4 lines, ये जो 16 होशंगाबाद विज्ञान शिक्षण कार्यक्रम के स्कूल, हो विशिका स्कूल इन शॉर्ट लाइक HSTP, ये जो हो विशिका के 16 स्कूल हैं, इनमें अगर कोई शिक्षक बच्चों के साथ हिंदी ऑफ फील्ड ट्रिप और परिभ्रमण पे निकला हुआ है तो उसके खिलाफ कोई कार्रवाई नहीं की जाएगी. क्योंकि परिभ्रमण पर बच्चों को ले जाना हो विशिका के पाठ्यचर्या यानी करिकुलम का अभिन्न हिस्सा है. ही मेड ए यू नो हिस्टोरिक स्टेटमेंट इन इन हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडियन एजुकेशन सिंस मैकॉलेज मिनट्स ऑफ 1835. हिस्टोरिक स्टेटमेंट. तो इज एसेंशियल नॉट जस्ट दैट नो एक्शन विल बी टेकन, ही कुड हैव स्टॉप देयर. ही एक्सप्लेन्ड बिकॉज फील्ड ट्रिप इज इंटीग्रल ऑर्गेनिक पार्ट ऑफ द करिकुलम ऑफ HSTP. ही वेंट वे अहेड of anyone could be expected from the government department. In the next monthly meeting, another complaint by another teacher. Sahab, bahut dikkat aa raha hai. Ye jo kit aapne diya hai, mere ko gadbad hai kit pe. Nahi, kit to theek diya aapne, par jab bacche experiment karte hain na to tod dete hain. Aur ye jo magnet hai na, ye to bahut pyara cheez hai na. Usko bacche chupchap bhi jeb mein rakh lete hain. अपने घर ले जाते हैं, अपने माँ बाप को दिखाते हैं, फिर माँ बाप को लगता है कि उन्होंने कुछ गलत काम किया, स्कूल का सामान ले आए. अगले दिन माँ बाप आते हैं, ये लिए आपका कुछ सामान है, वापस ले लीजिए. और ये बड़ी अजीब सी चीज़ है, सारा लोहा खींच लेती है. तो चीज़ें से वी ऑफ कोर्स एन्जॉय, वी एक्सप्लेन टू द पेरेंट्स ऑल्सो वाई लोहा इज अट्रैक्टेड बाई चुंबक. दैट इज फाइन, बट सिंस थिंग्स आर गेटिंग लॉस्ट एंड बींग ब्रोकन, व्हेन द स्टॉक विल बी टेकन एट द एंड ऑफ द ईयर, विल बी अ डैमेज एंड लॉस. Then all the damages will be taken out of our salaries. We'll have to pay at the end of the year. That is the rule of the government. So we cannot go on bearing losses of this kind. Again, DO was invited. He heard the whole story. Give me 2 days. He always asked for 2 days. And 2 days later, he issued another letter, another DO. Again, a historic DO, which said, in this program, it is liable to be broken or lost. In bracket, losing is not a bad idea because magnet is very attractive for people to learn science. And this loss will never be charged against the salary of any teacher engaged in HSTP in 16 schools. Another problem over. These are not small matters. If you know the Department of Education of every state government, how it thinks, how it operates, how the rules govern their minds, not the other way around. These are major decisions being made without consulting the DPI office, without even informing. History was already being made. Third monthly meeting. Every time there is a new problem. This time the problem was, the school inspector came and stood outside my classroom. Children were busy doing experiments. हमने कहा साहब अंदर आ जाइए. नहीं तुम्हारी क्लास में नहीं होगा. तुम्हारी क्लास में अनुशासनहीनता है, indiscipline है. सर नहीं साहब वो तो एक्सपेरिमेंट कर रहे हैं. देखिए आप भी कीजिए. मैं अनुशासनहीन क्लास में नहीं आऊँगा. I'll not come in an undisciplined classroom. साहब क्या गड़बड़ है? इतना शोर हो रहा है. क्लासरूम में बिल्कुल सन्नाटा होना चाहिए. चुप रहना चाहिए सबको. केवल शिक्षक का आवाज आना चाहिए. किसी और का आवाज नहीं आना चाहिए. या तो सारे बच्चे बोल रहे हैं. दे आर इंस्पायर्ड. चिल्ड्रन आर इंस्पायर्ड. दे आर ऑल्सो डिस्कसिंग विद ईच अदर. दे आर आर्ग्यूइंग विद ईच अदर. दैट वॉज द होल पेडागॉजी ऑफ HSTP. ये शोर बंद नहीं होगा तो मैं तुम्हारे खिलाफ CR में लिख दूंगा. वार्निंग दे रहा हूं तुमको. And he went away. So now solve it. Again, DO was called. He heard all that. 2 days later, he issues the famous DO. HSTP के होविश्का के 16 स्कूलों में शोर होना स्वाभाविक है क्योंकि बच्चे प्रेरित होते हैं, आपस में बातचीत करते हैं. ये तो वैज्ञानिक ज्ञान प्राप्त करने का रास्ता है, उचित रास्ता है. इसमें किसी को कोई दिक्कत नहीं होनी चाहिए. और मैं सारे स्कूल इंस्पेक्टर को बोलता हूँ इसकी इज्जत करें. आई मीन इमेजिन दिस. 3 स्टोरीज आर नॉट सिंपल स्टोरीज. आई रिपीट दे वी कुड नॉट हैव इमेजिन सच ए थिंग हैपनिंग. इवन टुडे दे लुक लाइक इम्पॉसिबल थिंग विच हैव हैपेंड इन द हिस्ट्री. दे ऑल पार्ट ऑफ द रिकॉर्ड्स केप्ट केयरफुली. आई मूव फॉरवर्ड. Rashid, still with us, kept on saying we should connect with more people so that the resource group of HSTP expands. Right? How do we do it? He said, look, when I got a NCRT talent scholarship, I was asked to work in Delhi University for my summer vacation with a chemistry professor, and he is himself on the same track, thinking of introducing experiment as a way of learning science in colleges and universities. He prepared a book also on this. But he has no such ground level experience like you people have. So if you want, I can request him to arrange an interaction. He arranged it. I think it was October of 1972 that I was invited along with Sudarshan to visit Delhi University. And a meeting was arranged by Professor Krishna Sane of the chemistry department. And people from physics department, from geology, from zoology, from botany, from all science departments, several people were present, about 60 or 70 people were there. But large number came, large proportion was of physics teachers. I think they were the most agonized teachers. That's why they were there. They heard the report a few months since March of that year. And they just could not believe that what they believe should happen in India has already started happening. And one of them said, Professor Vijay Verma now, Vijay Verma said that we have prepared a serious report for Delhi University. When students come from high school system, including private schools, the famous public schools of Delhi, when they come to us, they do not understand ABC of science. So we have to start again in both mathematics and physics from zero. And the first year is spent not on teaching the BSc level physics, but in teaching high school physics and mathematics. then they become ready to absorb the higher ideas. So we want to work in the schools and change all this. And suddenly we heard something like this is already happening. Very happy. Can we come and be part of your next program whenever it is held? We said yes. So in December, in this Christmas vacation, we had organized a 7-day workshop. They came, several of them came, 8 or 9 of them came, chemistry, physics and biology people. And they were genuinely impressed by what they saw. They said, this is like a dream coming true. Can we get associated with it systematically? Can you create a space for us? We were just waiting. It's like a boon coming to us. And each one of them was a gem. Is a gem. If they are alive, some of them are not alive. Each one of them is a gem, including of understanding of philosophy of science, not just method of science, in philosophy of science. So we said, certainly you're welcome. They said, we'll have to find a way out because we teach every day, all working days we are teaching, we cannot take off, there are lots of tests we undertake. So there's no space available, but we'll do something. They went back and wrote a formal proposal about 10 pages. We have a copy of that proposal, addressed to the Vice Chancellor with a request. This report may be presented to the Academic Council and later on to Executive Council for taking administrative decision. We want certain specified period when we take leave every month at the rate of 2% from each field, chemistry, physics, biology, geology, and go there for a certain period, maybe 2-3 weeks, come back and continue our teaching in the university. The Academic Council burst out in protest. And Academic Council said, this is rubbish. The UGC is paying your salary to teach at BSc, MSc level or do a PhD program. You're not being paid a salary to go to the schools and teach school teachers. Secondly, if anything is to be done in school, don't you think there are plenty of schools in Delhi city? Teach here. Do whatever you want to do here. You have no job, no reason to go to Madhya Pradesh and get involved in their program. So they argued because they've already created essential infrastructure, permission is there, therefore we want to go and join. Otherwise we'll have to create the same situation in Delhi city, which is almost impossible for us to do. Nobody was impressed by the argument. So the report was rejected. In the month of January, one of the philosophers, real philosopher of the entire group, called Pramod Srivastava, physicist, he sent a telegram, day after tomorrow reach Delhi and meet me outside UGC office. So I took the first train to Delhi and reached there in the morning. So, you know, January is very cold in Delhi. I didn't have proper clothes. I saw Pramod waiting outside the UGC office in a very heavy overcoat. I said, "Arey, bulaya tha, kam se kam kuch garam kapda to le aana tha." He said, "Arey, baba, bahut galti ho gaya." So why have we called? He said, because our report has been rejected by Delhi University, we are now approaching UGC for help. I said, is there any reason to have hopes from UGC? He said, no. No prior discussion, but I asked for appointment. A UGC chairperson, this is January 73, has invited me to meet. And I told him, you are coming, and he said, okay. He did not know any one of the two of us, but we were there in front of him. Professor George Jacob, then chairperson of UGC. So he had a written proposal, the modified version of what he gave in Delhi University. He read it quickly and he said, okay, what do you expect from UGC? All right, you are doing good work, you want to do good work in Madhya Pradesh, go and do it. Why have you come to me? He said, because we cannot take leave, and when we go away, who will teach in our place? All kinds of problems. So he thought for a minute and said, I think there is a way out. I think I can solve the problem. I'm very new here, but give me some time. So I asked, what is the way out? He said, we have a teacher fellowship program in UGC, which enables teachers to go for higher interaction, higher level interaction, higher studies, research, experience in their own field of study. History person goes for history, and physics person goes for physics in some other institution in the country. And in his absence, is allowed for about 4.5 months, one full semester period. In his absence or her absence, the university is allowed to recruit ad hoc teacher for those 4.5 months whose salary is reimbursed by UGC. While the salary of the teacher who had taken leave for higher studies continues to come from the same source, that there is no break in the salary and no problem in the pension calculations and other such matters. There's a continuity. So I said, you are yourself saying it is meant only for that subject. But here is a subject is not the point, because physics person will go and teach all kinds of fields of the science. And this is not for higher studies, higher research. So how will you do it? He said, that is why I asked for time. Otherwise, I would have offered a fellowship right here across the table. Give me time. I'll see what is to be done. There's a meeting of the whole commission in a week's time. I'll try to get a special permission from the commission. Commission allowed him to do it by modifying the proposal. Proposal modified to say it is not necessary that the person who takes teacher fellowship leave goes only for higher work, higher studies and research in her or his own field. Not necessary. It's preferred but not necessary. Another mandate being changed. And the same conditions will apply, rest of the conditions. By changing one sentence, doors for teacher fellowship were opened for Hoshangabad science teaching program. And that letter went to Delhi University. Now the same academic council, same executive council, same vice chancellor readily accepted and congratulated the Hoshangabad science teaching program team emerging in Delhi University campus. By using this name, by using exactly this name, HSTP team emerging in Delhi University is congratulated for support being given by UGC. Since that day, UGC became an essential part of expanding the program. The more volunteers, teachers you get, whether from government colleges of Madhya Pradesh or TIFR or from IITs or from Delhi University like universities, wherever you get them from, if they are willing to take the teacher fellowship, it will be coming forward. Because no limit was placed by Professor Jacob. Later on, when Kerala Shastra Sahitya Parishad was organizing the All India Bharat Jan Vigyan Jatha program, they needed teacher volunteers for their work to be taken forward. They heard about this program. They again applied, giving the precedence of HSTP. On that basis, the teacher fellowship was extended to them also. And number of other times later on in the decade of 90s. What I'm sharing with you, my dear friends, how a single idea, exciting idea of HSTP, kept on opening up new doors of the government system, which is known and correctly so as a very rigid, inflexible system with no sensitivity for any improvement in the system of education. Yet that same system was responding in an amazing manner. So a whole team from Delhi University was ready. They came to be known in later years because they started doing new experiments for Hoshangabad program, sitting in their own labs. The university allocated them a huge room known as the Hovishika room, and the entire group came to be known in Delhi University as the Hoshangis. And they were very proud to be called Hoshangis. Next several years they spent with us. And whatever Bal Vigyanik which Professor Subramanian was admiring, and rightly so, they are wonderful books written by lots of people together. The whole resource group is involved. Lot of work, lot of thought has been given, in which Delhi University people have played a major role, a decisive role. And they continue to play that if ever there is an opportunity. There's a story which I missed telling you about TIFR, very important story, of the first workshop. As I told you, the chemistry group was there, led by Ramu Ganguly. Is Ramu not around? I heard he's out of India right now. So Ramu told the teachers, we have worked very hard, we have beautiful new experiments which are conducted in the most advanced labs of Europe and America. We have brought those experiments in very simple manner. They will be presented to you. All do it. So next one day they kept on doing those experiments. They saw there was no response. Teachers are not getting excited. Teachers not getting involved, although experimental material was there in front of them. For whatever reason, for this particular chemistry program, the response was very limited. So they had a review of the whole thing overnight. And next morning, Ramu stands in front of the teachers and says, "Humne bahut socha ki aap log kal kyon nahi khush the. Humko samajh mein aaya, ye humne bahut dur baithkar kisi badi lab mein baithke kaam kiya hai. जिसका आपके ज़िंदगी से कोई लेना देना नहीं बचा है, इसलिए हम इस सारे मटेरियल को जो हम लाए हैं, इकट्ठा लिख के लाए हैं, जिसकी 40 कॉपीज़ डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड थे, फोटो कॉपीज़, ऑल फ्रॉम TIFR, हम उसको अभी आपके सामने उसको आग लगा रहे हैं. They were set on bonfire in front of the teachers. We want to get rid of them. We'll come back to you 6 months later with now the chemistry which will make sense to you, to your children and to your homes and families. They did that. They fulfilled that promise 6 months later. They learned. They unlearned and they relearned. Unlearning and relearning became a buzzword in HSTP. Lots of us unlearned and relearned and kept on doing it. As long as we are doing HSTP, we'll be unlearning and relearning. It's another beautiful story. Before I move on to the next phase, I want to go back and say the relationship between HSTP and Homi Bhabha Center is an organic relationship. In their first visit of Professor Yashpal and Professor Kulkarni, when they saw the situation of our schools, the really horrible situation infrastructurally, teacher appointments, teacher education, you know, qualification, all in horrible shape. So I remember when we were sitting at the bank of Narmada in Hoshangabad town, Sudarshan, myself, and Professor Kulkarni and Professor Yashpal. Professor Kulkarni was very worried. How will it happen in Maharashtra, in Bombay? Bombay had a particular problem by that time, very important problem which we dealt with in successfully in HSTP. Problem was the Director of Education of Bombay Municipal Corporation, Mahanagar Palika, told the TIFR scientist that in the third year of the program, by this time it was 1973, so before the beginning of the academic year, they told the TIFR scientist, our teachers have learnt a lot, they've enjoyed everything, we also appreciate whatever has been done by you people, but in the third year, teachers are informing me that they don't want to continue. In the third year, there will be a proper examination in class 7. An examination will not be based upon what you have been making children learn. It will again demand memorization, rote learning, and the children will not do well, and therefore teachers are writing letters to me to withdraw the program. So Professor Yashpal, given his persuasive power, tried his best. Professor Kulkarni tried his best. I am told even Professor Menon talked to the Director of Education, but nothing could be done to change the decision. This they knew before the academic year began in 1970, at the end of 72. So with this burden on their head, Professor Kulkarni kept on saying, "Wahan par ye problem hai, yahan pe halat kharab hai sabki." स्कूलों की कैसे HSTP जैसा आइडिया जिंदा रहेगा, कैसे हमारा आइडिया जिंदा रहेगा. वी नीड टू डू समथिंग. देन ही सेड टू प्रोफेसर यशपाल, डोंट यू थिंक वी शुड मेक ए प्रपोजल टू TIFR फॉर सेटिंग अप एन इंस्टीट्यूशन ऑफ नेशनल सिग्निफिकेंस विच विल प्रोवाइड फुल इंटेलेक्चुअल थियोरिटिकल प्रैक्टिकल सपोर्ट टू मेकिंग सच ए आइडिया सक्सेसफुल इन आवर स्कूल सिस्टम. दे अग्रीड. द आइडिया ऑफ Homi Bhabha सेंटर वॉज बॉर्न on the banks of Narmada in Hoshangabad. These are various connections. Later on, when Delhi University Group became involved with us at such intimate level, so the Vice Chancellor of Delhi University, I think Professor Raza, the Vice Chancellor at that time, he called these people, that I know UGC is funding you people, you are going there often to Hoshangabad, all wonderful work you are doing. Are you not concerned about your own university? Science education is in a mess. Don't you want to do something about improving the quality of science education in Delhi University? They said, we want to, but there's no space. Whom do we talk to? Say, talking to the Vice Chancellor. Tell us what is to be done. Out of that discussion, the HSTP Hoshangi group in Delhi University was inspired to write a proposal to set up a special kind of center in Delhi University with UGC funding. That was pushed by the Vice Chancellor, Professor Raza, and result was that today there exists a Center for Science and Communication on the campus of Delhi University, which is an offshoot of HSTP. There are various connections of this kind. I ran out of time. In 1978, the program was expanded from 16 schools to 280 schools of Hoshangabad district, all schools of Hoshangabad district, all the middle schools from class 6 to class 8. It was not so easy, you can imagine. much more difficult. Dr. Sharma was not around. Things were getting very difficult. Yes, we had, in the meantime, won the battle of examination. We went to the Secretary of Education in 1974, the year beginning for the last third year of the middle school, and posed the problem. She said, examination cannot be changed for your sake. So after some discussion, I said to her, I found out that your son is learning music in the evening through tuition. I said, yes, how do you know? He said, well, look, we do our research work before coming to you. He's learning to play sitar. She said, yes, that's right. Said, suppose he tested on tabla, would it work? Said, no, of course it would not work. That you have allowed us officially for last 2 years to conduct a science program which is based upon totally different premises than what you have been doing or anyone else has been doing in the country for last 100 years. Premises have changed. You have allowed us. Teachers have been trained. Teachers have been prepared for this. The whole ambience is different in the school system. She said, I know all that. Yet you want to go back and test them on rote learning. Don't you think you are going to do tremendous injustice to the children? She said, let me think. I'll call you. She called us after about 10 days. That time, just the same scene in 1972, behind her, all the department, same department officials, still there in the same position were sitting, including Sevaram Chaturvedi at the back in the corner, who was already involved in our teacher education programs and enjoying himself. And they spoke one after another. हम तो पहले ही डॉक्टर शर्मा को वार्न कर चुके थे वो सुनते नहीं ना किसी की हम तो बोल चुके थे मैडम इसको इजाजत मत दीजिए बिगाड़ देंगे अब देखिए दो साल करके इनको तो आत्मविश्वास नहीं कि इन्होंने साइंस सिखाई है इन्होंने साइंस थोड़ी सिखाई है पता नहीं क्या सिखाया है हमारे बच्चों की जिंदगी बर्बाद कर दी मध्य प्रदेश के बच्चों की और अब आप कह रहे हैं हमारा एग्जामिनेशन अलग होना चाहिए उसके पैरामीटर्स अलग होने चाहिए इवैल्यूएशन के ये सब कैसे चलेगा एग्जामिनेशन तो एग्जामिनेशन होता है ना अगर साइंस सिखाई है तो फिर डरते क्यों हैं लोग दे वर वेल प्रिपेयर्ड ये डर रहे हैं क्योंकि साइंस नहीं सिखाई ना आई आस्क्ड द सेक्रेटरी वुड यू लेट मी आस्क अ क्वेश्चन टू द एडिशनल डायरेक्टर सो यस श्योर आई सेड टू एडिशनल डायरेक्टर आई एग्री विद योर क्रिटिसिज्म सो लेट्स डू वन थिंग Our children from these 16 schools, which are your children, but these children plus those children of 280 schools, they all be examined in a common manner the way you have planned. But the papers will be set by us. Because you say science is same, nothing different. So let us set the papers. And it will be from the syllabus which you have approved, your own syllabus. Say, okay, chalega. We knew the pressure was going to come from the secretary. Chalega. So I went to the blackboard in the office and drew a curved line. उसको हिंदी में वक्र रेखा बोलते हैं मैंने कहा ये वक्र रेखा देखी आपने जी हाँ देखिए तो ये पहला सवाल होगा और बच्चों को कहा जाएगा कि इसकी लंबाई नापो जो चीज़ की जरूरत हो मांग लो नापने के लिए जो चाहिए मांग लो इसकी लंबाई नापो All of them shouted in a single tone. ये तो गलत सवाल है ये सवाल गलत है ये धोखा है ये नहीं हम पूछे देंगे मैं क्यों क्या तकलीफ है आपकी आपने कहा कि सिलेबस पे होना चाहिए हाँ सिलेबस पे कहाँ लिखा है वक्र रेखा नापो मैंने सिलेबस पे ये भी नहीं लिखा कि सीधी रेखा नापो सिलेबस पे तो ये लिखा है मेजरमेंट अंग्रेजी में हिंदी में लिखा मापन पर और कुछ नहीं लिखा है मेजरमेंट इंक्लूड्स एवरीथिंग मेजरमेंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ लेंथ There also measurement of weight and that's a different issue. आपने तो कहीं रोका नहीं ना कि इसका नापो उसका मत नापो हम तो आ गए आपको एक पत्ती देने वाले हैं लीफ लीफ की जो सर्कमफ्रेंस है उसको भी नापो आप क्या मना करेंगे उसमें मेजरमेंट लिखा है और सिलेबस में आके लिखा है ये बच्चों को नापना सिखाएगा सेंटीमीटर में इंच में फीट में और मीटर्स में ये लिखा कि नहीं लिखा हाँ वो तो लिखा है मैंने कहा मेरे पास है आपका सिलेबस ये लिखा है आप कैसे मना कर सकते हैं पर हमने तो नापना नहीं सिखाया ना मैंने कहा ये बात बोलो मैडम को हमने नापना नहीं सिखाया मध्य प्रदेश के 70,000 स्कूलों में आपने नापना नहीं सिखाया पर आपके 16 स्कूलों में नापना सिखाया गया अब आप मैडम को ये भी बता दीजिए कि क्या सिखाया आपने, बोलिए उनको, टेल हर, क्योंकि हमने उसकी डेफिनेशन याद करवाई. मैंने कहा ये भी बताइए, डेफिनेशन याद करने से नापना नहीं आता है, आपने नापना सिखाया नहीं, आप डेफिनेशन रटवाते रह गए, ये बच्चे बेकार हो गए, आपने जिंदगी बर्बाद कर दी. कल उनमें से बच्चे टेलर बनेंगे, कॉबलर बनेंगे, मोची बनेंगे, वो किसी बड़े कंपनी में जाके काम करेंगे, वो इंजीनियर में जाएंगे, डॉक्टर बनेंगे, सब जगह नापना पड़ेगा. वो क्या डेफिनेशन बोलते जाएंगे? तो उनको कहेगा सड़क की लंबाई नापो, तो क्या करेंगे? बोलेंगे नापने का मतलब ये होता है. आपने जिंदगी बर्बाद कर दी बच्चों की. दैट मेड एन इम्पैक्ट ऑन सेक्रेटरी. शी सेड आई विल राइट द लेटर, ऑफिशियल लेटर गिविंग यू परमिशन टू होल्ड ए सेपरेट काइंड ऑफ एग्जामिनेशन इन 16 स्कूल्स. And that letter opened amazing doors for us. The divisional superintendent of education in charge of exams in 5 or 6 districts, he called us in his office. Saab, ye letter aaya hai, isme likha hai ki ho vishika samuh jis tarike se bachcho ki pariksha lena chahta hai, us tarike se le 16 schoolon mein, aur mulyankan ke maapdand, parameters of evaluation, wo khud tay karenge. उसकी रिपोर्ट वो पहले प्रपोजल बना के लिख के दें, उसको अप्रूवल मुझे देनी है तो मुझे आप लिख के दीजिए, आप कैसा एग्जामिनेशन लेंगे, क्या क्या करेंगे उसमें, सब लिख के दीजिए डिटेल में, मैं उसको पढ़ूंगा और अगर ठीक लगा तो उसकी इजाज़त दूंगा. व्हाट डिड वी राइट? वी रोट इट ओपन बुक एग्जामिनेशन विद इनफॉर्मली वी बीन प्रॉमिसिंग द चिल्ड्रन दैट कीप योर रिकॉर्ड्स ऑफ द एक्सपेरिमेंट्स केयरफुली. द वर्क बुक विच इज रिप्लेस द टेक्स्ट बुक, हियर इज द वर्क बुक. It replaced the textbook. This workbook does not give you any knowledge. It only tells you how to conduct an experiment, which you have conducted. Whatever observation data you have collected, write in your notebook. They used to write. Write your inferences after discussion. Logical inferences, record them. And when you will be examined, you will be allowed to take your workbook and your answer sheet, your notebook. You will be allowed to take both of them. And in excitement, our Delhi University friends or myself also used to say, केवल ये दो चीज नहीं, आप तो जो मर्जी किताब आपको ले जाने ले जाइएगा. तो विश्वास नहीं करते थे. Now the divisional superintendent saying, give us a proposal. We wrote open book exam. Children will be allowed to take any material they want to take, because it's not going to help them. The answers will be like measuring the curved line. Will not help you if you are carrying 10 books with you. Even engineering books are not going to help you to measure the line. So we wrote open book. We also said one part will be experiment based, another part will be based upon written answer. We did not use the word theories and practical, which is the byword in Indian education since Macaulay, 1835. Everybody said practical karenge. Practical ka matlab kya hai? Theory mein se practice kya nahi nikalta? There's a dialectical relationship between theory and practice. So why are you saying हम practical करेंगे और theory अलग होगा? Same, they have no difference. They are the same thing, extension of each other. The practice leads to theory, theory leads to practice. Any scientist will know this. So why this distinction? Because you don't believe either in theory or in or your what you call practical. So practical you can just waste time. You know? Practical is no meaning. 10 numbers of practical giving without conducting anything. For 20 numbers, there's a big show going on in Maharashtra right now. You know, the 10th class results. So, open book, experiment-based examination separate, test, use the word test. And there, all kinds of questions will be asked, as written in your in the handout given to you today, that courage to explore new knowledge. Not just talk about the knowledge which you already gained, courage to touch other frontiers, open new frontiers of knowledge. That courage will be tested. Your imagination to think of touching the new frontiers while testing you. How to do it? Our proposal was approved. Division Superintendent of Education said, prepare your teachers for this. Teachers don't even know ABC of this kind of a system. So we spent huge amount of our time with the help of Delhi University, TIFR, IIT friends, and the government college teachers from Madhya Pradesh, various colleges who were working with us just to prepare our children to demolish Macaulay and Manuwad. And think beyond all this. Transcend Macaulay and transcend Manuwad. It was a major battle in Hoshangabad program, which we actually never won properly. Things were very difficult, but the very fact that the examination system as holy or holier than Ganga Jal was allowed to be transcended by HSTP. It's an amazing thing. When the very first attempt, teachers, as children took their bags and loaded it, despite Yashpal report of loaded curriculum, against loaded curriculum. They loaded it with books, that some book might be useful, helpful. And they came out after the examination hall, written test, that not a single book was required because it was not going to help us. Next year, nobody took any books. पहले साल बहुत हल्ला हुआ, नकल करवाते हैं, ये करवाते हैं. Then it all became lost in the memory of the people. They understood what was happening. I want to tell you a story of the politics of the whole thing. It was never without political opposition from various sources. There's not enough time for it, but let me quickly mention one story which happened in 1985, by which time Eklavya had been founded in 1982. 10 years after the program started, Eklavya in 1982, Keshava Bharati founded it. By this time, Rasulia had dissociated from the program for practical reasons. We were carrying forward the flag. And we were feeling overworked, overstressed, without appropriate number of people. There was a running joke in Keshava Bharati discussions that adhai log HSTP chalate hain. Adhai log, do log pakke hain, aadha koi ye hota, kabhi wo hota. Adhai logon ka program hota hai. Rest of people are doing other things. Keshava Bharati was doing a number of things. Apart from running a nai talim school, working on reproductive health of the people, working with labor, landless labor, organizing landless labor, working with the youth in various ways. We were involved in n number of programs in which HSTP was one of it. And the running joke was adhai logon ka kaam hota hai, baki to koi hai hi nahi karne ke liye. And whenever I was late in returning back to the campus, so let's say 8 p.m. in the evening, 8 p.m., and I'm not back from some school. So people at the Keshava Bharati campus used to say, he must have met a group of students. He must have gotten involved with the students and must be conducting experiment on that particular pagdandi, sitting at a pagdandi. Everyone was so excited. If children stop you, you have to start doing experiments all over. When the first time we made electric motor in the classrooms, 1 week later I was passing through a chai dhaba, and class 7 student studying in that son of that owner was sitting and making chai, and he said, "Arey sab idhar aiye, main aapko ek naye dhang ki electric motor dikhaunga, wo wali nahi jo aapne sikhai hai, humne to wo sab chhod diya, humne naye dhang se bana liya, ghar mein hi bana liya." So much of enthusiasm happening all over the HSTP school areas. The people were inventing things, making new things, and getting excited about it. Not only this, the kit was being replaced. I remember when in a girls' school in Bankhedi, they were going to go on a field trip and they asked me to come along. I said, okay, so I went along. They went to the farms outside the village. And then the teacher, lady teacher, asked the girls, ki aaj hum sir aaye hain, ye phoolon ka bahut badhiya study karte hain. To aaj inke samne hum phoolon ko kaatenge, unka jo female part hai wo nikalenge, और उसमें से अंदर से ओवरी निकालेंगे. तो आप लोग अपनी नीडल्स लीजिए और निकालिए. दैट टाइम नीडल्स ऑफ दिस काइंड वर पार्ट ऑफ द यूज्ड टू बी बॉट फ्रॉम द मार्केट एंड यूज्ड टू बी पार्ट ऑफ द किट अगेन फॉर कंडक्टिंग 10 ग्रुप्स डूइंग द एक्सपेरिमेंट फॉर 10 नीडल्स. इट कॉस्ट मे बी अबाउट 20-30 रुपीज पर स्कूल. सो गर्ल सेड, मैडम आज तो भूल गए लाना. शी वॉज वेरी एंग्री. आपको बताया था कि सर आएंगे, जिन्होंने हमको सिखाया है वो आए हैं और आप भूल के लाना, हमारी क्या इज्जत बची? इज्जत ही नहीं बची अब हमारी, हम क्या बोलेंगे इनको? ऐसे ही होता है क्या हर बारी? पहले तो लाते हो तुम, इस बार कैसे भूल गए नीडल लाना? तो क्या करें? तो गर्ल से, बहन जी मैं इसका अभी रास्ता निकालती हूँ. एंड शी वेंट टू ए बबूल ट्री, एंड बबूल ट्री यू नो two spines grow together like twin. She broke from the tree one twin of two spines, two thorns, and said to her friend, tu ye le le aur isse main karti hu, karke dikhao jaldi se, wo andar jo hota hai wo nikal ke dikhao, anda hota hai. That day the 30 rupees worth of needles were taken out of the kit and they were told babul ka kaante se kaate. There was an experiment in class 8, I think, acid-base and neutralizing base with the acid. And to know is neutralized or not, used to add a drop of phenolphthalein, and phenolphthalein being an external material in the villages. So it was provided in a small bottle. It also was cumbersome, not only cost, you to divide the purchase phenolphthalein into small bottles, seal them properly, and then provide it. Cumbersome. In one teacher education program, one teacher who had come for the first time was watching it after district level expansion. He was watching the experiment and said, "Ye maine hote hue dekha hai. Ye pehli baar nahi dekh raha hu. Ye jo hai na, uska gulabi rang aana, pink color, uska gayab ho jana. Ye maine dekha hai. Kahan dekha hai? Ye gaon mein dekha hai. Main aapko bataunga, maine dekha hai." Then couple of hours later, he says to us, "Main bataun kahan dekha hai? Hamare yahan ek ayurvedic doctor hai gaon mein. वो जब उसके पास कोई पेशेंट आता है, उसकी मेज के ऊपर एक सफ़ेद गिलास में पानी रखा होता है, उसमें कुछ डालता है तो वो गुलाबी हो जाता है। फिर वो कहता है, देखो तुम्हारा खून ऐसा होता है, तुम्हारा खून है ना, वो पतला हो गया है, वो खराब हो गया है, फिर उसमें कुछ डालता है तो गायब हो जाता है, देखो ऐसा हो गया है। Then the patient is very impressed, they always take medicine from him. मैं तो उसके पास जाऊँगा और कल सवेरे लौट के आऊँगा, आपको बताऊँगा वो क्या चीज़ है। He came back next morning and said, "I talked to the doctor, he was hesitant to reveal his secret, but eventually revealed and said that it is sold in the market as a medicine for improving the digestive system." Chemistry people study, have you ever known that phenolphthalein is a cure for disorder in the digestive system? So he bought it 1 rupee from the local bazaar and said, "Ye hai wo cheez, isko karke dekho, aap ya karke dekho." We did it with acid base, it worked just like phenolphthalein. It was phenolphthalein. In very fine print it was written, sodium salt of phenolphthalein. That day we were liberated from providing phenolphthalein. By the time program was going on in the district level, it has spread, news has spread, many supporters and promoters all around us. There was a media report by a well-known journalist of today who wrote, a title of his report was, "Sava Rupay Mein Vigyan." I know why he said that. He said this because he had come to visit our teacher education workshop and he said, "Kitna paisa lagta kit dene mein? Ye kitna mehenga hai? Government kar sakti nahi kar sakti? Government hi to kar rahi hai. गवर्नमेंट का तो पैसा लगा है, गवर्नमेंट ही तैयार करती है, बांटती है, ये गवर्नमेंट का तो काम है। गवर्नमेंट बाय दैट टाइम हैड क्रिएटेड फॉर डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल एक्सपेंशन ए स्पेशल यूनिट इन द डिविजनल एजुकेशन ऑफिस, स्पेशल यूनिट हुज जॉब वाज टू प्रोवाइड किट, साइंस किट, द वे वी हैव एडवाइज देम, एंड यू शुड ऑफन टेक हेल्प फ्रॉम अस, दे यू शुड कॉल टीचर्स टू हेल्प देम, दैट्स अ डिफरेंट इशू। सो वी टोल्ड हिम दैट इट कॉस्ट 1100 rupees पर स्कूल for providing adequate material for 3 classes, 6 to 8, for children conducting in each class in groups of 4 each, 10 groups, conducting more than 300 experiments in 1100 rupees. He said, "That is all?" I said, "No, there's one more additional cost, there's some breakage, losses, that comes out to be at a yearly basis, annual basis, 1 rupees 25 paise per child." So, Sava Rupay Mein Vigyan became a famous slogan of SSTP. It's Sava Rupay Ka Vigyan hai, and government kahti hai paisa nahi hai, theek kaam karne ke liye. On the issue of money, I must mention, when the district level expansion had not taken place, we were still in 16 schools, and government was paying for the TADA of the teachers also, and the food expenses, and we were going to propose district level expansion, we were worried whether government will deny permission on that basis. We had gone to meet the new DPI, we were sitting outside his room. A clerk came who used to often say and greet us. We were known by all the peons of the offices, all the clerks of the offices. The clerk came with lots of files with him. He stopped. "Why are you people sitting here? Sudarshan bhai, aap kyun yahan baithe hain? Kya baat hai? Koi problem hai?" So he said, "We come here to find out whether finance will be provided for district level expansion." "For what purpose?" "For training." They use the word training. "तो अभी तो देते हैं ना, अभी तो आप 40 मास्टर के लिए देते हैं ना, 50 के लिए देते हैं, उस समय तो आपको 700 टीचर्स के लिए देना पड़ेगा। कहता, मैं आपको एक सीक्रेट बता दूं, हमारे पास स्टेट गवर्नमेंट से डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल साइंस एजुकेशन की वर्कशॉप और ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम करने के लिए जो पैसा आता है वो इतना ज़्यादा है किसी भी साल में ख़त्म नहीं होता, वो लैप्स हो जाता है, वापस चला जाता है, फिर आता है, फिर लैप्स हो जाता है। इसके कारण अब उसको घटाया जा रहा है। इस अगले बजट सेशन में हम ज़्यादा नहीं मांग सकते, क्यों करें, पाँच साल से तो अब यूज़ नहीं कर रहे हैं, अब उसको काट देंगे। आप ऐसा कीजिए, जल्दी से बैठ के कैलकुलेशन कीजिए, कैलकुलेशन लाए थे, ये है बस, मैं साइन करा लूँ साहब के, फिर आप जाइए उनको ये बताइए कि आपको टीचर एजुकेशन के लिए पैसा चाहिए, आपको मिल जाएगा परमिशन। आफ्टर 10 मिनट्स ही केम बैक, ही सेड, मैंने कह दिया उनको कि बहुत पैसा है हमारे पास। When we went there, he said, I know why you come. You want money to be given for teacher training. I said, not to us, to the district education officer. He said, I know that. We will give it. He said, for 700 teachers. Yes. Any number of times in the year, there's adequate money. I've just confirmed it. Don't worry, money will come. For 30 years, when Eklavya was created in 1982, from then onwards or before 10 years also, not once anyone had heard from state government of Madhya Pradesh that they do not have money for promoting science education program of this kind. Not once. Therefore, my last story. I conclude with that. In 2002, by which time Eklavya had extended the program from out, went beyond Hoshangabad district as was mandated in formation of the Eklavya institution. They had taken it to 12 or 13 other districts. In each district they took a school complex, an idea borrowed from Kothari Commission, 1966 report, where each school complex had 4 to 5 schools for management purposes. So they had taken 4 to 5 schools in 12 or 13 districts outside Hoshangabad. And they had also started covering other subjects. They started a social science program for middle schools under the guidance of Professor Harbans Mukhya from JNU and his students, Rashmi and Subbu, whom you probably know. And the science education was taken forward by Hardy, who is his popular name, Hridaykant Diwan, Venerable Raina, no more now with us, and many other such people who worked with us as research scholars, young research scholars, for the previous 10 years. A new team for social science, a new team for primary education had already come up, and that team was working under the program called Prathamik Shiksha Karyakram in a neighboring district, Betul district, and doing work with language and mathematics. Very innovative, creative work. In the language, they had a guidance, benefit of guidance of Professor Ramakant Agnihotri, presently working in Udaipur also, retired as head of the Department of Linguistics from Delhi University, one of the best known linguists of the country. And he gave wonderful advices. One of the advices which I'll quickly mention and go beyond it, he said to us that learn to repeat sentences in different ways, different styles. You people write your workbooks like precise scientific material. The people who are not exposed to reading in the previous generations or the present generation, not surrounded by academic material, this is the first exposure to reading anything seriously, you cannot be as precise as you have a habit of being in scientific writing. Learn to write like Premchand wrote. Like Premchand wrote, he said, he repeated the same thing in many different ways. If he says, yahan par bahut sardi hai, toh aaj koi lakdi pe lagayenge, alav jalayenge, toh kehta, haan, jaisa pichle saal bhi alav jalaya tha na. Learn to write like that. So a lot of HSTP books were rewritten on the basis of this advice from a linguist. All kinds of such inputs were coming in the years when Eklavya started to work. And I don't have now a time, I will not take any more time. We have to finish the story. In a Sabaliram imaginary figure, which we invented during the 16 school stage, and then made it an official figure as part of the bureaucracy, when Savali Ram was accepted by the district education officer as an imaginary figure. Imagine, district education officer and the later years divisional education officer. The Savali Ram address used to be Savali Ram. Savali Ram. It used to be Savali Ram, Jila Shiksha Adhikari Karyalaya, Hoshangabad and PIN code. All the letters which children wrote to Savali Ram asking questions went to district education office. They sorted it out. They knew the expertise areas of all the people of SSTP resource group. They to send those, they divide all the letters and send to different people for answers. The answers will go. If the answers were not forthcoming in time, then there used to be objection by the children. Ek hafta ho gaya, abhi tak Sawali Ram ka jawab nahi aaya. Children became, they thought really a Sawali Ram existed. Sometimes they would ask, kabhi school mein aate ho to Sawali Ram ko bhi saath leke aaya karo na. So Sawali Ram is a great figure. Imagine, now I understand TIFR Hyderabad campus has working with Eklavya to document the Sawali Ram questions and making it a research program. That's a great idea. So Sawali Ram letters were written, and I want to just read one or two lines from this, because here is a conceptual step forward for which Eklavya has to be congratulated, which we are all struggling with. And when we handed over HSTP to Eklavya team, new team, we talked about this issue, but we did not know how to resolve it. Resolution was done by Eklavya. So the HSTP, the Sawali Ram letter, which always published as a introduction to every Bal Vigyanik, this is I think 1994. This Sawali Ram letter shows the conceptual development. Well, sometimes many questions are asked. It says that you have done many experiments up to class 8 book. Now we'll be going to class 9. वहाँ पे कुछ दिक्कतों का सामना करना पड़ेगा, उसके बारे में कुछ कहना है. पहली दिक्कत ये है, वहाँ कोई प्रयोग नहीं करवाएगा तुमसे, तुम प्रयोग करके सीख नहीं सकोगे. हाँ, जस्ट शो इट व्हेन आई लास्ट वन पार्ट फाइव पार्ट फोर जस्ट शो इट. किताबों में पढ़कर ही हर बात सीखनी पड़ेगी, लेकिन एक बात और ध्यान से सुनो, प्रयोग करके सीखना वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट. नाउ प्रयोग करके सीखना ही एकमात्र तरीका नहीं है. Experiment, learning from experiment is not the only way to learn. They expand upon it. पहली बात तो ढेर सारे ऐसे प्रयोग हैं जो हर जगह हर हालात में नहीं किए जा सकते. All the yellow highlighted sentences. कोई भी प्रयोग हर जगह नहीं हो सकता. Atomic energy का प्रयोग आप मेरे गांव में नहीं कर सकते ना, आप यहाँ भी नहीं कर पाएंगे. चाहे अणुशक्ति की जमीन पर हैं तो भी नहीं कर पाएंगे. हर जगह नहीं किए जा सके. दूसरी बात, हम हमेशा नहीं कर सकते कि हम खुद प्रयोग कर ले तभी हम बात को मानेंगे. दैट्स हैज बीन द स्लोगन ऑफ हम खुद करके से आए ना, जो आपने देखा होगा कि ये वाला सबने देखा होगा. मैंने सुना भूल गया, इन चाइल्ड हैंड राइटिंग. मैंने देखा याद रहा, मैंने करके देखा समझ गया. So we are now questioning that. That's not adequate. Not adequate. That's important but not adequate. We have to transcend that also. दूसरी बात, हम हमेशा नहीं कर सकते, हम खुद प्रयोग करेंगे तभी मानेंगे. दूसरे लोगों के द्वारा किए गए प्रयोगों को पढ़कर भी हम सीखते हैं. Now these children are going to go to 9th and 10th, where the HSTP is not running. इसलिए किताबें पढ़ना भी सीखना एक बहुत ज़रूरी काम है. बगैर सोचे समझे किताबों को रट लेना कोई अकलमंदी नहीं है. होशंगाबाद विज्ञान में सोचने, तर्क करने, आपस में चर्चा करने, समझने पर जोर दिया गया है. शायद आगे की कक्षाओं में तुमको ऐसा माहौल नहीं मिलेगा, परंतु माहौल तो बनाने से बनता है ना. ये माहौल बनाने के लिए मुझे और तुमको मिलकर कोशिश करनी है. मुझे सवाल ही राम, वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट कंसेप्चुअल डेवलपमेंट. इन 2002 in the month of June, a sudden order comes out of blue. No prior report, no prior indication. जब आग लगती है, लोग कहते ना कहीं ना कहीं तो चिंगारी हुई होगी ना, तभी आग लगी है. यहाँ तो चिंगारी भी नहीं देखी किसी को. Order comes, the same kind order, plain paper, the office of the education department, etc. DO letter. Three line letter, they are very precise in giving orders. Three line letter, उसमें लिखा था ये जो नया अकादमिक सत्र 2002-03 शुरू हो रहा है, इसमें जिन जिन स्कूलों में होशंगाबाद जिले में और उसके बाहर के जो जिले हैं उनके नाम ब्रैकेट में थे, इन जिलों के 12 और 13 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स, जहां पर होविशिका चलता है वहां पर होविशिका की द्वारा लिखी हुई किताबें और छपी हुई किताबें अब इस्तेमाल नहीं की जाएंगी. ये नहीं कहा होविश का बद्ध हो रहा है, उसकी किताबें इस्तेमाल नहीं की जाएंगी और जो किताबें प्रदेश के बाकी स्कूलों में चलती हैं वही चलेंगी. गवर्नमेंट न्यू व्हाट दे वर राइटिंग, दे न्यू द बुक्स विच आर रिटन बाई HSTP रिसोर्स ग्रुप आर पब्लिश विदाउट एनी चेंजेस बाय द टेक्स्ट बुक कॉरपोरेशन ऑफ भोपाल और मध्य प्रदेश गवर्नमेंट, पाठ्यपुस्तक निगम. ऑल दीज बुक्स सिटिंग हियर आर पब्लिश बाय पाठ्यपुस्तक निगम. इफ यू डोंट एंड दे यूज्ड टू बी सोल्ड थ्रू द लेजिटिमेट बुक सेलर्स ऑफ द पाठ्यपुस्तक निगम टेक्स्ट बुक कॉरपोरेशन, सो द मार्केट वॉज ऑल्सो हैंडल्ड बाय देम. सडनली एट अ टाइम दे वोंट बी यूज लेटर सेज, दैट मीन एंड ऑफ द प्रोग्राम. लॉट ऑफ प्रोटेस्ट टुक प्लेस, many meeting, public meetings, rallies were taken out, black flag shown to the leadership, I'm not naming the leadership, black flag shown. Then many scientists came to know, some leading scientists of the country wrote letters to the chief minister. They included not only of course Professor Yashpal, but included Dr. M.S. Swaminathan, included many people from the Atomic Energy Commission. Many letters went to CM, what have you done? And he had gone on a trip to US for getting investment, foreign investment for Madhya Pradesh. In his trip to US, he reached Massachusetts Institute of Technology, Harvard University, everywhere the Indian students gathered him and protested. Nothing was changed. That three-line letter prevailed. The program came to a sudden end. Why? My answer is given in my handout here, also in the poster sent out. Answer is very simple. World Bank, after 1991 structural adjustment of globalization, had decided to destroy the vast school system of India at that time with 8 lakh schools. That had to be destroyed. How do you destroy? You cannot say chhu mantar and it's destroyed. They knew in order to destroy it, you have to enter the program and start dictating terms. The structural adjustment terms said Government of India should start now declining expenditure on public programs like education, like health, like subsidies for agriculture, farmers, like whole range of welfare programs like widow pensions, all kinds of programs which Government of India, state governments fund on a massive scale. The public expenditure in those programs must be declined, order of the structural adjustment from International Monetary Fund and World Bank. For showing how to do it, they entered at least the primary education program. 18 states of India, more than half of Indian primary schools, were being dictated terms by World Bank for next 10 years, starting from 93 onwards. In the process, they destroyed whatever was happening in the primary schools. Infrastructurally, teacher training, teacher appointments, all were destroyed. The idea of a contract teacher was born as part of the World Bank structural adjustment program. And curriculum and the idea of knowledge, notional knowledge in the curriculum was reduced to meaning only literacy and numeracy. All this had happened. Single teacher schools were being opened. Single room schools were being opened. All this is history and well recorded, well documented by many people at many places, including me. So in 2002, World Bank had to see that this program, and by that time it had expanded to 750 government schools, 500 of them in Madhya Pradesh in 14 districts, and rest of them in schools of Rajasthan and Gujarat, also government schools. Program would have expanded to other states. Kerala Shastra Sahitya Parishad were negotiating with Eklavya to help them to start it there also. Karnataka Science Movement people were also negotiating. World Bank knew if this goes on and quality of schools keep improving, the quality of knowledge keeps improving, the epistemic transformation in the school system, then their program of destroying government school system will not work. New counter model was emerging, counter to structural adjustment. Therefore, this had to be stopped. With a strong will, which government never had earlier, now the strong will be given to the government, and government passed a three-line order to wind up HSTP immediately within the next one month. It was done. Therefore, I have recorded in my write-up today also with you that if you want HSTP-like pedagogy, HSTP-like vision of education, HSTP like freedom for the teachers and teacher educators to innovate, to create, to open new spaces, democratic spaces, emancipated spaces, then we have to build up a resistance movement to undo the impact of neoliberal political economy. There's no other way out. I do not know of any other option. If you know any other option, let me know. Jai Hind.
So, thank you, Professor Anil Sir. Thank you for this sharing of the narrative of Hoshangabad Vidyan program. But now, if there are some questions, if anybody has any questions, so Professor Sadgopal is willing to take them. Yeah, I'm just seeing who is. Okay, so you can give up. Then you.
Thank you for coming. Very grateful.
Hello, sir. Very interesting talk. I am a chemical education researcher coming here from US. To learn, definitely, that's what my goal is. But I'm very surprised to hear what you mentioned in the last 5 minutes. And what I understand is the inquiry-based movement actually also was gaining in United States in terms of instruction. It also became a movement in there. And I'm wondering about, you know, what's the connection? Because I feel like this, what you did in Hoshangabad started pretty much, and it is an exemplary program. It's an exemplary moment, actually. So I'm wondering, when you said that they wanted to kill this moment, was it because they wanted to take it off somewhere? That's what I'm wondering about, because if you see that inquiry movement actually also advanced to a certain point in US, and that's that, until the next generation science standards came up, it was actually pretty much encouraged. Now it's on the, it's still there, it's on the decline, it's not really, you know, peaking, but this what you said is, I feel like, was it, you know, historically, I don't know, but seems like you started much earlier than they did.
Here we are talking of not education of the elite, we're talking of education of the masses. That's number one. We're not talking of what is understood as the prescribed knowledge from prescribed textbooks. We're talking opening up the doors to new knowledge, new ways of acquiring knowledge, and enabling our children of the masses to not just have literacy and numeracy, which takes them nowhere, in fact, but go much beyond that, become thinking people, thinking citizens, questioning students, who can question what is going wrong in our society, question the caste, question patriarchy, question the class, question exploitation, question the loss of our sovereignty, raise questions which people don't raise. We're preparing them for that. It's a new way of looking at what is knowledge. This can be very frightening to any state. In addition to that, we have the problem of structural adjustment, which is imposed on us by IMF and World Bank, which said in clear terms, reduce our public expenditure in all these fields which I mentioned. Reduce it. Why reduce it? A, because you do not have enough money. So reduce it on the public expenditure, which is for the welfare of the society, for the masses' welfare. Reduce that. The same IMF World Bank never advised our government that also in the process of reducing, stop giving income tax exemption of 3 lakhs to 4 lakh rupees to the corporate houses. Never told that. That continued. Indebtedness of the farmers cannot be subsidized. We won't subsidize the farmers. We won't subsidize the unorganized sector, which is 93% of Indian productive force. All that will be withdrawn. We won't educate the children. We won't provide good health system, public health or medical support. None of that will be supported. But we'll support the growth of a corporate capital by giving them tax exemption every year. This year also is to be announced shortly. Every year it has been announced. We won't ask the government in India to not allow any public sector bank to give bad loans. I mean, don't we know that public sector banks know not to give a bad loan? It's not that they are stupid, foolish people, they are giving bad loans. They know what they are doing. But they are being made helpless, compelled to give bad loans every year. So 5 years ago, it was 2.5 lakh crores of rupees. Today, more than 10 lakh crores of rupees. All that will be now subsidized by the people of the country. All our corporate leaders will be subsidized by us, by all of us. We are middle class, by even the masses. They will be subsidizing the corporate capital. All this is part of the neoliberal political economy, with a crisis of resources, the crisis of market. That is a crisis of capital. There's cycles of crises through which capital is going every year. So that capital needs more resources. They want to enter Jharkhand, they want to enter Chhattisgarh, they want to enter Madhya Pradesh tribal area. They want to take over all the forest, all the mining resources. They want full support of the Indian police and army behind them when they go and exploit people. They want all that. They will be supported by the Indian state. At the same time, they want privatization of the schools. Schools cannot be privatized unless you destroy the public funded education system. You know it if you come from America. It has already happened in many states of America. In America, 30 years ago, essentially all children went to public funded schools, government schools. Today there are many states, like New England is one of those areas where there's a heavy privatization. I think New York and California are standing out with some strength and still resisting privatization. So you destroy government funded school system in India. That was a requirement in order to privatize. As a result of what happened in the decade of 90s, we have the huge growing, not just privatized, but heavily commercialized market. And the commercialized market of schooling has changed the notion of education, what is good knowledge, what is good education. Changed the whole thinking of our children. So it is taking away our languages, it's taking away our history. I'm not talking about history which the present dispensation talks about. I'm about history of rebellion, history of revolution. Why will private school dedicated to commercialization will teach Bhagat Singh? Why will they teach Ambedkar or Phule or Periyar or Narayan Guru? Why will they talk about how Khudiram Bose his whole life and eventually was shot dead because he's talking of revolution? History will not be taught. So it's an attack, it's an epistemic attack. It's an epistemological assault on Indian education. Not just schools, colleges, universities. That is why universities are being privatized and commercialized. Campuses are being sold. The immediate agenda in higher education today is not to strengthen all the universities of the state governments or the central government. Agenda has been announced. Open, double the number of the so-called eminent universities, world-class universities. World-class universities, what does it mean? They will rank high in the top 200. Who does ranking in the world? Market. In the market, companies doing marketing of universities rooted in the New York Stock Exchange and Tokyo Stock Exchange, Beijing Stock Exchange, who are doing the marketing. Marketing agencies do ranking. On what parameters? How many people coming out of a university get placement in corporate houses, multinationals? We don't want those parameters. We want our ranking. How many people coming out of your university will serve the people of India, will resist exploitation and oppression, will fight for the real freedom of the people of our country, will bring back Bhagat Singh, memories of Bhagat Singh in Phule, Ambedkar, Periyar, Narayan Guru, apply it to destroy caste system, demolish, annihilate caste system, using Ambedkar's language, annihilate patriarchy. That is the kind of citizenship which our commercialized universities, institutes of eminence and world-class universities don't have the courage to even think about. They have sold out their conscience to the market promoted from stock exchanges. All this is a total holistic phenomena of neoliberal attack. Yet capitalism is going through crisis after crisis. It's the innate nature of capitalism now to go through crisis. It can be saved only by socialist reconstruction of Indian society and Indian politics. There's no other way I know of. If you know better ways, please tell. I do not know. I only remember recall the last few sentences, maybe 3 weeks before Bhagat Singh was hanged in 1931, when he wrote his famous Kaum Ke Naam Sandesh, message to the people of our country. And he wrote this here, that we are not fighting just for transfer of power. He asked, mockingly he asked, what difference will it make to the people of our country if in place of Lord Reading and Lord Irwin, we will have Thakur Das and some other name he gave. What difference will it make? Then he asked, goes on to say, unless we, while liberating India from the shackles of imperialism, we also take India on the path of socialist reconstruction, there'll be no difference made to the people of our country. Today, after 3 decades, Bhagat Singh is more true than he was in 1931. 3 decades of globalization.
Thank you so much, sir. Though I have many questions, but whatever you said, well, it was a part of some of my questions. I have one more question. Yes. Like, India is a country where the education system is quite different from other part of the world. And here, I think we need a different method, a different way to run an education system. As you right now said, the last sentence, we need a political liberal method to come out of this problem. So, sir, if there are some students who really want a reformation in Indian education system, so what your guidelines that what should be the first starting point of a student or those reformer should take? Because it's a big challenge for a student. There are so many fights a student need to face when he or she is on a way to reform education system in India. What should be the first challenge, the first step he should take in this field?
Are you a PhD scholar here?
It's a master in education.
What is your research area?
Right now I have just stepped in this field of education. So I need to know, okay, like, from where should I really need to work so that I can resolve the
no,
problem?
No, if you are undertaking research, you must undertake research and find out the truth. Find out the satya. Don't bypass it. That's my suggestion to you. But answer to your question is available. The days of reform of the kind you are interested in, I'm interested in, all of us are interested in, days of reform are over. I know this reform word is a neoliberal word, but now I'm using the reform word in the context of our constitution. Neoliberalism and constitution are contradictory to each other. Hey, if you want, I can expand about it, but I'm sure you know that. In the context of perspective of the constitution, the days of reform are over. There are no ways known to people like us. They can now reform. The great wonderful opportunity which Madhya Pradesh government gave us in 1972, it was not prepared to give us after 2002. People ask me, can we re-establish HSTP? I said, no chance. In 1972, India was, although it was not a welfare state in the real meaning of welfare, at least it was feigning to be welfare state, trying to show to the people, convince the people that we are a welfare state. We are still following the Constitution of India. But today, Constitution is in danger. And what kind of reform will you do? If you say, we want to provide every child and every youth equitable quality of education, this agenda will mean death of neoliberalism. And neoliberalism's death cannot be wished for. You have to fight for it. Neoliberalism is a management strategy of capitalism to survive. When Jharkhand people say no to the decision of the state government to take over their mines, and they agitate, they take out rallies in Ranchi and they are shot at or their leadership is imprisoned or all kinds of false charges are put on them, what will you do? You'll say, we are asking for reform in the mining policy. Whom will you say this? The ruling class itself is advocating and imposing that mining policy at the behest of the multinational corporate capital. Please recognize it. This is not a simple thing. How will you deal with it by saying, I want better education for all children? We all want better education for all children. Who will say, I want bad education for our country's children? You'll only be allowed, permitted to work within the given constraints and never challenge the constraint. The moment you challenge the constraint, you'll be thrown out as HSTP was thrown out. Therefore, most of the NGOs have learned to adjust. Instead of transforming the school, they found many escape routes in order to survive. So they say, all right, we are not allowed to improve the school system, so we'll wait until evening or late afternoon when children come out of the school, hold special classes, and fill up the gaps of the schools. They don't call themselves coaching classes, but no different from the coaching classes. But they're happy with it. They feel we are doing something good for our poor people. Depends upon what conscience you have. Is the conscience be satisfied by opening a coaching class in the evening for children of the government schools? Or would you rebel and go to the roots of the problem and fight against the ills of the entire system? I'm just recalling Gandhi's beautiful words. I was writing something about Gandhi a few days ago. Very powerful words. He was referring to the Macaulayan system. And he was saying, it's somewhere around 1924, wrote in Young India. He says, the system must be scrapped, referring to the Macaulayan system. And now building up the Nayi Taleem for free, independent India. The system must be scrapped. Inquiry must be instituted and action must be taken to liberate us from the shackles of Macaulay's education. Such powerful words. And we need to use those words again and again. I quoted it in the context of 1924. I quoted it in the epilogue of my article. What he said in 1924 needs to be said right now in 2019. I re-quoted. And I mean every word of it. And I met IAS officer by chance in the last few couple of years. Amazed, those IAS officers tell me, well, you know, you are HR, you are an educationist. Oh, good, good that you meet me. I like meeting education people. Very happy. And he says to me, you know, we have done something very good in our state in recent years. What is this? He said, I was education secretary, I started this. What is that you started? We are doing activity-based program. I knew about what he's doing, what the state is doing. I said, yes, I know. So we took help from Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu is doing activity-based program, so we have started it. I said, don't you read the history of your state when you become IAS officer? He said, what do you mean? I know the history of the state. Did people not tell you, for 30 years, we did not do activity-based in the state. The activity is major dilution of the whole idea of knowledge. We did experiment-based learning of science, not activity-based learning. He said, is there a difference? I said, of course. Activity is meaningless and directionless. It does not prepare you to deal logically with the situation. Experiment-based learning is based upon the method of science and scientific temper. So it has been done in Madhya Pradesh. Then I somewhere mentioned, your government provided kit to 750 schools. Oh, we also provide kits. So he called his assistant who came with files. And he asked me, you have any queries? I said, yes. I asked a concerned person, I said, the kit which you gave, Is it meant for demonstration by the teacher or for hands-on experiment by the children? सब इतना तो नहीं मालूम रहा हम देते हैं एक्सपेरिमेंट होता है एक्टिविटी भी होता है हर बच्चा करता है सब बच्चे ही करते होंगे एंड आई एस ऑफिसर इंटरव्यू गई नहीं सब बच्चे करते हैं मैंने कहा कैन आई सी योर लिस्ट आई जस्ट टुक वन लुक एट द किट लिस्ट बिकॉज वी ऑल इन्वॉल्व इन मेकिंग किट्स आई सेड दिस किट विल अलाउ ओनली द टीचर टू डू एक्सपेरिमेंट्स हाउ डू यू नो आई सेड रेड द किट लिस्ट Took me 1 minute or less to know it is meant only for the teachers. I cannot imagine the state government of today would think of getting children to do experiments with their own hands. Cannot imagine in the present day of neoliberalism. It's adjustment made, another mockery of the whole idea of experiment-based learning of science. These adjustments they will make. If you want to be part of that, become part of it. That's your democratic right. You want to fight against it, destroy, use Gandhi's language. The system must be scrapped, inquiry must be instituted, and Macaulay's school system must be destroyed. I'll add, Macaulay cum Manuvadi's school system must be destroyed. There's no way out. If you're not willing, this is what we are doing in our All India Forum for Right to Education, which I represent here. We are fighting for building up only two-point program. It's written in my introduction of the poster. Only two-point program. Build up a nationwide common education system from KG to PG, entirely cost-free for every child, irrespective of class or caste background or gender background. Equitable, free of all kinds of discrimination. With children of the denotified tribes, children of the transgenders, everybody has an equal right to education. That's the Constitution of India speaking, I'm not speaking. Read Article 14, Article 15.1, Article 16, Article 21. I'm reading the Constitution, interpreting it for education. And KG to PG, higher education also has to be free. If you don't do it, you'll have a doctor whose parents have spent 50,000, they spent on the doctor 5 crores of rupees to make their doctor MD. When the doctor comes out with an MD degree, what do you expect the doctor to do? What is her or his top priority after getting an MD degree, a 5 crore degree, for which the parents have taken a loan? Their property is mortgaged. The topmost priority of that doctor would be to mint money out of practice so that loan can be paid back and property can be retrieved from mortgage. How will the doctor be able to fulfill the Latin oath which every doctor takes at the time of getting degrees? I'll serve the society, I'll work for the patient, work for the ill, remove, eliminate disease. How can this doctor do it? It's not that there's something wrong with that particular human being. You compel that human being in such a situation, the doctor will know only to loot the people of India. You're compelling engineers, you're compelling computer hardware people, computer software people, now artificial intelligence scientists. Everybody is being compelled to loot the society, exploit the society. And inequality has increased beyond imagination now. In 2017, you must have read, 1% of Indian people collected 73% of the income of 2017. The gap between rich and poor is higher than it was ever in India. Not even in British India it was so bad. Whom we shunted out of the country because they were exploiting us. And whenever you increase in inequality, you create tension in the society, instability in society. Then beautiful ideas of good education don't matter then in that society. Things are of that nature now. Inequality is a basic fundamental problem of Indian politics and Indian society. Fundamental problem. Poverty is a consequence of inequality. We should all know that. We should realize it with our heart. Dil se samjho is baat ko. Dimag se nahi samajh mein aayega. Garibi isliye nahi ki garib log hain. Garibi isliye ki ameer log hain. इतने अमीर हैं कि बिलियनर्स हैं We are so proud of saying now we are coming close to the American list of billionaires. Billionaire becomes billionaire only by exploiting the poor, the 93% of the unorganized sector. These are the real hardcore situation. This is the coordinate of our political economy and our society. How will you introduce equitable education of good quality for every child in India, every youth in India? Therefore, in All India Forum, on one hand, we are fighting against common education system, for establishing common education system, a democratic, scientific, secular, enlightened education system that will liberate the people from their shackles of enslavement. On the other hand, we are fighting against commercialization of education. Our demand is to stop all foreign direct investment in education. We're fighting for that. Fighting against all attempts to do public-private partnership in the field of education. Because that means transferring people's money, which is kept in trust by the government, passing the people's money to rich schools and to rich sections of society, which is the mool mantra of the present government and the previous governments also, PPP. So PPP has to be scrapped, using Gandhi's words. Has to be scrapped if you want to save not just education, health also. India is a rich country whose people are poor. The rich country is not going to help the masses of our country. Otherwise, it won't become rich. We'd rather be like Bhutan, a small little country, dependent upon Indian protection. His education system is a common education system, where children of the royalty also study. And they don't talk about economic growth rate. They don't talk about becoming superpower. They don't talk about how much resources they have to make satellites and rockets. They say our index of society is happiness index. Hum khushal log hain. Hamare school khushal hai. Hamare aspatal khushal hai. Hamara samaj khushal hai. I think Bhutan should become our new Vishwaguru. Will be happier people. Any other questions?
Sir, my question was related to the activity kit related thing only. Basically, you've answered that. But in our school, I'm teaching in one of the schools in Mumbai, and our school has activities for all the students. Every student perform the activities. The kits are provided. But I just wanted to know that during your time when you said that HSTP, your program, and that time government was sponsoring those 16 to 17 schools.
Not 16, 17, 750.
Okay, 750 schools.
I'm giving kits.
That's what. So you said Sava Rupay Ka Vigyan, somewhere it was mentioned. Yeah. So at that time, if government could afford of that state, why can't the government afford right now? Now, if there are many private companies which are coming up with such kits, like, and they are charging, like, you're talking about 500 rupees per kit.
1100 rupees.
At 1100.
Yeah.
They're charging 5000 rupees per student for around 8 or 9 kits, sir. Mm. In that case, if you'll see, it's bomb amount for a school, whatever it may be. But if that is the situation at that time, government could afford, how is that government not able to afford now?
Two answers. Both I've already given. I'll give it again in a different manner. At that time, the state government in Madhya Pradesh and other states also was not under the pressure of structural adjustment program. It could decide how to use its money, number one. Second, it was not under the pressure of privatizing its schools by giving public by doing public-private partnership, by passing on its money under different names, under different excuses to the private schools and the owners of the private schools. These two pressures were not there. Its only agenda was to improve the government school system in education. Therefore, the government schools in cities like Bhopal, Indore, Gwalior, Jabalpur, and X number of other places were among the best up to mid-90s, among the best. People used to line up, queue up in the schools in order to get their children admitted. They used to get recommendations from MLAs and IAS officers to get their children admitted. And today those school buildings are empty. They've been destroyed. When ACER reports, ACER brings out a report annually, Pratham report, and they report how children do not learn, how many do not learn. Every year I look through the beginning and the end of the report to find somewhere one page, half a page saying how this situation has been arrived at. How the children who were learning very well in 70s, 80s and 90s are not learning anymore. What has gone wrong? I even talked to the leadership of that organization. Please write a paragraph. Just don't report how many don't learn. To write half a sentence, how many don't learn how to divide or multiply of two-digit numbers. That we know they don't learn. Tell us how it happened, how the disaster happened. Institute an inquiry and write the report of the inquiry before discrediting the system year after year. But they want to discredit. Rather than analyze, the analysis will lead them to very painful conclusions. It's a planned conspiracy to destroy the government school system. I said India is a rich country. At that time, the central government was not required to exempt 3 lakhs to 4 lakh crore rupees of taxes of corporate capital. In 70s and 80s, this was not the situation. It started after globalization. It was not required under any political pressure from outside to reduce subsidies. There was no WTO in 70s and 80s or even up to mid 90s to tell us you cannot liberate the farmers from the debt they are suffering from. There was no WTO controlling our decisions, no World Bank and no IMF controlling us at that time. Whole situation is transformed. If we don't deal with the questions of political economy, we cannot solve the questions of welfare, education, health, and happiness, which Bhutan has solved.
There's one last question I'm allowing. Yes. So let's
raise it. It's on. So all these truths that you were talking about, have been reading about it for like 5 years and got too agitated reading the newspaper every day. So I came to Mumbai to do my MA in education. And after listening to you, I just have 4 words. Is there still hope?
What, you did what?
Is there still hope for our education system?
I wrote in my today's handout also. There's a lot of hope. There's a lot of hope. Hope is always there. Without hope, there's no need for me to even stand here. There is hope. And there's hope when we analyze India's politics and political economy intelligently, logically. Then we reach a conclusion to build up a resistance movement. When Gandhi said, burn the foreign cloth, it's a very violent mandate he adopted, very violent. A person of non-violence says, burn the cloth. Why did he do so? He gives figures. Read Hind Swaraj. He gives how 60 crores of rupees at that time, it was a very big number. 60 crores of rupees are being lost by India every year because we buy foreign cloth. So instead of importing foreign cloth, start producing, start weaving, spinning right here. You won't need the foreign cloth. We'll save 60 crores of rupees for the poor people of our country. So burned it. He arrived at this through economic analysis. There was no other option which he had but to give this slogan and lead the movement for burning cloth. So you have to analyze the situation. Why salt satyagraha? Because salt was going to be imposed levy. You cannot take levy on salt, which is taken in every family of the country. His march was symbolic. But the British government, under symbolic march, had to withdraw the levy. So if my lecture does not make sense, please read Hind Swaraj. Read this very powerful book called Law and the Lawyers. Recently somebody gave me, I read it. Law and the Lawyers, written by M.K. Gandhi. And Introduction, they are written by someone else, editor. Talks of what happened in the trial held on 18th March 1922 in Ahmedabad. Here is a person almost naked with lion cloth standing in the place for culprits. And the judge enters, some Mr. Bloom whom he enters, he takes his seat and bows down before Gandhi. Gandhi returns a bow and smiles. And then Gandhi says, can I make a short statement before you read my written statement? He says, yes, you can make. You may make your statement. So what does he say? He said, you have charged me with sedition under 124A. Same charge which was put on Kanhaiya Kumar. Same charge. 124A. You charged me under 124A. He's a person who's a barrister also, lawyer. Under your law, which I don't accept, under your law, I'm a culprit. You want to punish me? Punish me to the hilt. I request you, Mr. Judge, to give me the severest possible punishment which your law permits. I'll take the punishment. But I refuse to accept the law. I have a powerful statement. I refuse to accept. And here's my written statement, you can read it. A written statement is also quoted in that book by someone, by the editor, a part of it, where he says, you came here to exploit us and loot us. You looted us enough. You did Jallianwala Bagh. You massacred the people. I reject your rule. I don't accept it. Now do whatever you want to do. Such powerful, clear words coming from Gandhi. What more do you ask for from a person like me? Nachis se kyo poochte ho? Main kya jawab dunga Gandhi ke samne? Hum to nachis hai na? पर कम से कम उनसे प्रेरणा तो सही ले लें. हम फिर बात तो नहीं पूछेंगे मुझे अभी भी अच्छी शिक्षा करनी है, मैं बच्चों को अच्छा कैसे पढ़ाऊं, मैं एक पेड़ के नीचे बैठ के पांच बच्चों को तो अच्छा पढ़ा दूं. पढ़ाइए पांच बच्चों को. आई रिकॉल एंड आई शुड फिनिश. माय डियर फ्रेंड सुग्रा इज गेटिंग इंपेशेंट. माइट हैव हर्ड ऑफ दिस द प्रॉबली द मोस्ट रेवोल्यूशनरी ट्रेड यूनियन लीडर ऑफ इंडिया इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया, शंकर गोहन योगी फ्रॉम छत्तीसगढ़ एरिया. ही वॉज शॉट डेड in 1991, because he became too revolutionary for the Bhilai steel plant and all the big corporate houses there. I'm not going into that story. But he, about a month before his assassination, he wrote an article on environment. I think that is a very appropriate thing to recall. His name is Paryavaran Se Kya Seekhe? Environment Se Kya Seekhe? What do we learn from environment? The beautiful, powerful article, we have published it. In that he says, he refers to the attack on Iraq by the United States with all kinds of poisonous bombs. Then he says, I have grown 5 trees of date trees, khajur. मैंने खजूर के 5 पेड़ अपने आंगन में लगाए हैं, अच्छे उग रहे हैं. पर मेरे घर के 5 पेड़ क्या इराक के लोगों के ऊपर जो जहरीली गैस के बम फेंके जा रहे हैं उससे उनको बचा लेंगे? आई थिंक आई डोंट नीड टू ऐड एनीथिंग मोर. आई कंक्लूड. My gosh. I also clap. My gosh, you should have mentioned while I was speaking. Your grand uncle.
Yes. As you have mentioned, he was the only one who was agreed.
Only person with a Gandhian conscience in the entire department.
I felt to share it with you. Thank you.
And you are a Bhopal person?
Yes, sir. I am.
Okay, meet me for a while. For a while. We'll join hands to build a resistance movement in Bhopal.
Friends, yeah. who all have, I see that you have 2 young ladies talking about their MBA or whatever study. My only request is that if your intent is there, intent is a very powerful word. And in Hindi, it is niyat. everything depends upon our niyat and our intent. If it is there, don't give it up. It is a great opportunity. You are listening to this person. And about Niyogi, he published the life of Niyogi. Can you believe this? And the money was collected, 5,200, 100 rupees, 10,000 rupees or whatever. So it is that, you see, he has a pacemaker there now. I was worried ki how much more energy he is going to pump out. But whatever is in your mind, collect with like-minded people. That is the only and only way. Nothing to fear about it. Whatever you can do in your given circumstances, that is important. And thanks for this powerful inspiration by you people who have asked such positive questions, which shows your intent. But please do not allow it to dilute. That's the only friendly advice I can share with you. Thanks, Anilda.
Thank you. And I'm sure there'll be more questions outside. So let's meet for tea.
Yeah, thank you.